Apart from that, there will be a members program and some good video clips. We have 2-3 member singers who are going to entertain us with their songs, and some good video clips also will be showing. We have been mentioning that there will be members program, and some of the members inform us that they would like to present some item. So even without the notice, if somebody is ready with a really interesting item to be presented, please let me know. So if the time permits, we will be able to permit that. I am happy to announce our speaker, Dr. Boraiah, is already here. So we will start the program as usual with our prayer. So for the prayer, you may stand up on your seat if you can. If you cannot, you can remain seated. And I will invite Asha Ben Dharavat to sing the prayer. Asha Ben.
जय श्री कृष्ण. हे प्रभु आनंद दाता, ज्ञान हमको दीजिए. शीख सारे दुर्गुणों को दूर हमसे कीजिए. हे प्रभु आनंद दाता, लीजिए हमको शरण में, हम सदाचारी बने. लीजिए हमको शरण में, हम सदाचारी बने. शांति चाहक धर्म रक्षक वीर व्रत धारी बने. हे प्रभु आनंद दाता, प्रेम से हम गुरु जनों की रीत ही सेवा करे. प्रेम से हम गुरु जनों की नीत ही सेवा करे. सत्य बोले झूठ त्यागे, मेल आपस में करे. हे प्रभु आनंद दाता, निंदा किसी की हम किसी से भूल कर भी ना करे. निंदा किसी की हम किसी से भूल कर भी ना करे. दिव्य जीवन हो हमारा, तेरा यश गाया करे. हे प्रभु आनंद दाता, हे प्रभु आनंद दाता, हे प्रभु आनंद दाता. जय श्री कृष्ण.
Thank you very much, Asha Ben. Nice prayer. Apne, as usual, karyakram ne shuruaat, we will be doing it with the welcome address by our president, Jagdish Bhai Patel. So I invite Jagdish Bhai to address us. Jagdish Bhai.
Thank you. Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Jalaram Sarvali. To all my Indo-American senior citizen members, I welcome you all for today's program. As you all know, ISCC has conducted value-based programs for its our members. So that programs are helpful for day-to-day life of our members. Today's presentation is by a person who is well known in our Indian community. He's a Dr. Srivastava Boraiah. His introduction will be given later by our member, Dr. Arpi Shah. I have appreciated that Dr. Boraiah for attending today's program and for giving his valuable time to our members. On behalf of our members, I take this opportunity to thank you to him. Thank you, sir. Lately, ISCC has started program jointly with India Home, and today's program are sponsored by India Home. My sincere thanks to Executive Director Dr. Vasantaraji of India Home, who supporting the Indo-American Senior Citizen Centers. It's also because of our Paramarshak, Sri Mukundbhai, who over the years have built up strong relationship with many tri-state organizations, and as a result, we are seeing all current benefits to our Indo-American Senior Citizen Centers. I believe God cannot reach everywhere, so God had created sevaks like Dr. Vasundaraji and Dr. Sri Mukundbhai Mehta. My special thanks to all invited guests and our EC members who have worked very hard to make this event successfully. Also, special thanks to Pakaji, who has always supported Indo-American Senior Citizen with donation and any other needs for our communities. Before I hand back mic to Pankaj Bhai, I have announced to make one announcement. My granddaughter Shanal, I always call her Shani, who started at age of 6 lemonade stand in front of the house every summer with the help of her friends. She and her friends raised funds by selling lemonades and other stuffs and donated the raised funds to children cancer hospitals. So let me call her and she will give you all the details. Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Jana.
Hi everyone, today we'll be telling you about a fundraiser we raised for a charity named St. Mary's Hospital. We set up a lemonade stand in our neighborhood to raise money for the children in need. We hope you can help support our fundraiser that we set up. Not only do we enjoy this because we're raising money for others, but also to have a fun experience. Before we begin, we're going to introduce ourselves. Hi, I'm Chanel.
My name is Avery and I love spending time with my friends.
Last but not least, I'm Isabella and I love my bunny.
Welcome everyone once again. We are so excited to tell you about a fundraiser. So without further ado, let's get started.
In our neighborhood, us neighbors and our brothers, we set up a lemonade stand every year for the past 3 years now.
We not only sell lemonade, but we also have other options, such as cookies and cupcakes, also at a reasonable price.
We also have different varieties of lemonade, like pink lemonade or just regular lemonade. Our lemonade is fresh and delicious and perfect for a hot sunny day.
In addition to the food and drinks we've prepared, we also sell bracelets, all made of a different meaning and uniqueness.
For example, here's one now. This bracelet I'm wearing right now represents creativity and a positive energy, which tells me it's going to be a great day today or any day.
We hope you could stop by and help support us. Not only do you get refreshing lemonade or sweet treats, but you could leave with a smile on your face knowing that you're also helping others.
If you do decide to come support our fundraiser, come stop by at the corner of Continental and Valentine's Drive at 2:25 p.m. today.
Thank you all for listening. Have a nice rest of the day.
Thank you, girls. Now they are going to be the future Indo-American volunteers. So we all seniors, with the presence of such kids, we feel little younger. Now We, as Jagdish Bhai has always mentioned, our mentor, our Paramarshak, Bukund Bhai is here. So let us have his blessing before we start the meeting. Bukund Bhai.
Thank you, Pankaj Bhai. And there is no blessing from me, as I always say, there are always the best wishes. Good morning, friends, or good afternoon. Welcome to this meeting. We are definitely really lucky to have an eminent doctor today, Dr. Boraiah, who is a really expert in his field. And we will definitely take advantage of his knowledge today. I think some of you, or maybe many of you, might have undergone some sort of medical treatment for your knee. It may be the knee replacement, or maybe a temporary relief from the injection of cortisol, PRP, or prolotherapy, like that. So these are the people who have undergone the medical treatment. Now I want to ask the question to those who have not gone through any of this medical treatment and who have not developed so far the knee problem. Can you raise your hand? Dr. Boraiah, we are really we are really a senior group who are really lucky to have that type of thing. Yeah, very good, that's nice. I know many members here are his patients, including myself. Some of you have undergone his knee surgery. I have gone through his hip replacement just 3 months ago, and he's a really expert in the field. Without talking too much, I'll hand over to Pankaj Bhai to proceed further. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mukund Bhai. As rightly mentioned by Mukund Bhai, lot of us, including Pakaji, Mukund Bhai, Maya Ben, everybody, and there are so many people here, they are raising their hands, so I will not name everybody, but they are there. What happened was, my wife, Varsha, who is unfortunately today not feeling well and not here, but about a month back, I asked who is the best person to be consulted because she has some problem, and so many people said that there is the only one person, and I went to him, and as is my habit, I asked him on that day that we are having an organization and can you spare some time to give us a talk, and he readily, without hesitating even a moment, he said, yes, I can come, and he gave me his cell number. And thereafter, Dr. Shyam Rao, he followed up, and we are able to have him today with us. So we all feel fortunate that such an eminent doctor, who will be most appropriate person for our seniors, is amongst us today. You may be already aware that this is the third program in August by Indo-America. We did picnic this month, we did bus trip to Vraj, and this is the third program. And if you have already noticed, for many years, it has been tradition of Indo-American to have two value-based program every month. Unlike any other organization, we put more stress on value-based program, which is informative, educative program, or encouraging the seniors for their benefits. That type of program, we continuously, on every month, we handle, we arrange. So today is the program that even after doing two programs in a month, we have made it a point to have one more value-based program this month. This week is a special week for all of us. You will ask how. First was that this is the week when we had Seniors Day. 21st of August was the Seniors Day. So belated congratulations for Seniors Day. And the matter of most pride for every Indian, that our rover Pragnan has been successfully launched by India, and we cannot be having enough proud for that. What an achievement for our country, and all of us are feeling so elated because of this achievement. So we are meeting in such a week where we have two good news. I already mentioned before the meeting that today, apart from the talk by Dr. Boraiah, we are also having some members program. We'll be showing some good video clips. And at the end of the program, please do not forget to pick up the Usha food coupon for dinner. So we will talk about many other things after this talk. But in the meantime, I will ask Dr. Shyam Rao, our Vice President, Public Relations, to introduce our today's speaker. Dr. Shyam Rao? Oh, sorry. This was originally planned. And he is the person who is so instrumental in bringing him, but we entrusted this duty to Dr. R.P. Shah. So I will request, sorry. I don't know. This is the senior's moment. So, Dr. R.P. Shah, I will request him to Dr. Boraiah, please.
So you can imagine I'm the replacement. Anyway, it is my pleasure to introduce this young man, the speaker. I saw him that he's so young. So let me, at the outset of my introduction to him, we are lucky because he doesn't know that we are going to live more than 50 years. So he's stuck with us for 50 years. That's one thing. And everybody calls him Dr. Boraiah. So let me add my one more line for that. His first name is Srivatsa. But South Indian, they speak Tha instead of Tha. But let's say Srivatsa means son of God. So we are under the good care of Son of God. Shri Vatsa. Vatsa means beta. So he's like that. So we are under good care of Dr. Shri Vatsa. Few lines are more important, and I have underlined even in my speech also to introduce him. Some larger fonts, bold fonts. So for you, let me tell you one thing. Do you hear good? Okay. Dr. Shri Vatsa Boraiah is a board certified orthopedic and joint reconstruction surgeon. For us, it's a joint replacement, but he will tell you more about why that reconstruction is important in this day and age. And he's an associate professor of School of Medicine at Hofstra/Northwell. He's a team member of, nowadays they call provider group, so is a team member of Northwell Health Physician Partners. But all we know, and is more important for us, is that he's affiliated to our neighborhood hospital, which is North Shore Hospital and Long Island Jewish Hospital, LIJ. He speaks English, Hindi, Kannada, and he doesn't know that very soon he's going to learn Gujarati from us. We Gujaratis don't learn everybody's language. We teach them our language, so it's easy. So he is going to learn Gujarati. About his little resume, I will say, Dr. Boraiah took his medical degree at JSS Medical College, Mysuru. We speak Mysore, but now it's the Mysuru, Bangaluru, something like that. So medical college, Mysuru, India. He did his residency training at the New York Medical College at Westchester. He was also a chief resident there. Now that is a very important thing. For a surgical resident, chief surgical resident is very important because it gives him more hands-on training. He has completed his adult reconstruction fellowship. Now again, ask him more about the reconstruction, because we are not accustomed for reconstruction or preservation or something, so he will tell you more. At the Langone, NYU Langone, which is Joint Disease Hospital in Manhattan. He also did traveling fellowship, specialized in hip preservation in Switzerland, Zurich. Dr. Boraiah is an active member of all the associated professional societies all around, especially including American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons. He holds, that is where Gujarat is come now, he holds multiple patents in medical devices. Let me tell you, my friends, we are Gujaratis, business people. We might invest some money if the doctor opens up a profit sharing business from these patents. We are very keen for that. You go ahead, we make money. Let me end this intro with one liner. Dr. Boraiah is specialized in hip and knee replacements and computer assisted surgery, because this is a fashion nowadays, robotic surgery. So he does that thing, computer assisted surgery. His special interest, and that is very important to end this thing, his special interest is preservation procedures. I just told you, preservation, and reconstruction. I request more from him. Thank you very much. Bye bye.
Thank you, everybody, for having me. Unfortunately, I can't speak Gujarati. I only learned Hindi by watching Hindi movies, though, because we don't speak much Hindi in Karnataka, where I'm from Mysore. But I really thank the opportunity. I think giving back to the community is as important as learning things, right? Because that's one special thing about medicine, medical field is, you know, your professional career, you're doing whatever you're doing, but giving back to the community, that satisfaction you probably never get in any other field. You know, I have friends who are investors, who are business people, you know, who do tremendously well. But I think the satisfaction of giving back to people and community and taking care of people is something you could probably never get in any other field. So I think giving back to the community, I think is very important, very satisfying. So I think I'm happy to every day in the morning to wake up and go to the job and make people happy and, you know, help them at least in part to change their lifestyle and give them the quality of life back. So again, I thank you very much for having me here, and I'm not going to bore you too much with the medical science of orthopedics. I'm just going to keep it simple. And I guess I also thank you for the great introduction. And I fixed Dr. Mukundbhai's hip. I tell my friends and colleagues there's nothing I can't fix. But that's just the hips and knees. But I also run the fellowship at Northshore and LIJ. That is like a specialized training after you're done with residency. And I'm also the chief of joint replacement at Long Island Jewish Hospital. So yeah, there's a lot of responsibility involved with it. And I'm just gonna go over quick some guidelines or like things that you guys need to know. When I got the call to say that talk about the seniors, this is joint replacement in seniors, I was just gonna, the first thing that came to my mind was, well, this is not exactly senior. So what exactly defines seniors? I mean, I think that's something subject to debate. Is 55 senior, is 65 senior, is 75 senior? What is senior? What do you think? What is senior age in your mind? 65, just because it's Medicare, 65. Retire, right. But I have some people who are my partners who are also 75, 78, they're still working, they're limping, but they still work. So senior is a very subjective term. I mean, a lot of people, if you ask them, I think in my mind, like people who are like under 40, they try to like lessen their age. If you ask them, how old are you? They say 35, 38. People who are like 80, if you ask them how old you are, they say they're 85. So it depends on which way you're standing and which way you're looking. But I think the key is to say, okay, I'm trying to look back a little bit and not say I'm 85, because if you say that, then you don't, you know, you just want to be slightly younger and enjoy your life. So try and make a point to say that I'm 65 instead of 70. So that just gives a psychological benefit to say, oh my God, I want to have a good life, instead of saying, yeah, I'm just going to hang out, I'm a senior. But having said all that, there's truth to it, medical truth to it. 65 years is Medicare age, but I think Medicare is going to go bankrupt if they keep providing all the 65-year-olds with health care, because people are living till 95, 90 now, you know, the lifespan is definitely increasing. So having said that, if we could pull up the presentation, I think it was on already. You can put it in that mode, that's fine.
If it cannot be on the Zoom, let it be at okay. least for this purpose. Okay. Forget Zoom.
So while we're just pulling this up, I'm just going to say, just that it's a little bit pertinent to Indian population. My mom had a knee replacement. She was in India. I did not do it. My friend was anesthesiologist for the surgery, and she's doing very well. My mom complains a lot, and she hasn't complained. Let me rephrase that. She has complained much less, so she's doing fine. I'm just going to say the incidence of hip issues in Indian population for some reason is very low. I don't know why, I can't remember your instance, but accident, right. So short of that, most Indian people don't get hip arthritis. I don't know why, it's just the genetics of it, but the knee arthritis is extremely prevalent. Gujarati people aside, every sect, like starting from north to south, the knee replacement is very, very prevalent. Especially Punjabi people who have a lot of bowed legs. And so long story short, hip surgery for Indians, if somebody needs a hip replacement, you got to really think, do they really need hip replacement, or is something else going on, or some spine issue going on? It's because hip issues in Indian population is very, very low. I don't know why God gave Indians good hips but not good knees. So without anything, we'll talk further about it. If you can go to the next slide, please. So what exactly does arthritis? So people always, I'm just going to keep this very basic so people can understand. So what is arthritis? So let me say, what is osteoporosis? People say, I have osteoporosis. Osteoporosis and osteoarthritis are totally different things. The word osteo means bone. Arthritis means it's related to the joint. Porosis means it's just weak. So osteoporosis means weak bone. It has nothing to do with the joint. If you scan people, population of Northeast who have seen a little bit of very little sun, they all have osteoporosis, especially Indian women also have a lot of osteoporosis. The reason being, first of all, number one, the activity level of sports is kind of lower. The weight in general is lower, and they're not exposed to sun as much. So in general, just in Northeast, the osteoporosis incidence is very high. Now, if you have osteoporosis, it doesn't mean you have arthritis. Now, arthritis just means your joint is worn out. It can be from any reason. Most common reason is osteoarthritis. Now, people have rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, traumatic arthritis. If you have an injury or something, you can develop arthritis. The word arthritis just means your joint is damaged. That's it. So now osteoporosis and arthritis are very different things. It's kind of important to understand that what's the difference. So what are the symptoms? So arthritis can happen anywhere. Anything, the two bones that moves in the body will have arthritis. It can be knee, it can be hip, it can happen in the neck, it can happen in your fingers, it can happen any joint that moves. If it happens in the spine or in the back, where there is, when people bend, right, there's bones that bend. So when arthritis develops in the spine, you develop degenerative changes in the spine, which can give rise to sciatica, low back pain, and some kind of nerve pain going down the legs. So in essence, it's just the same problem. It's the arthritis, it's the wear and tear of the joints. And I also say why some patients develop arthritis and why some people don't develop arthritis. So that's the question, right? So people come to me and say, oh my God, I abused my knee and I developed arthritis. To some extent, it's true but that's not always true, because people who run marathon, all of them don't develop arthritis, right? So there's a reason. So the way I explain people is, if you have a car, if your wheel alignment is off, right, if your wheel balance is off, your wheel wears out, the tire wears out quickly. So if you naturally have some malalignment, if you have a little bit of a bow leg or a little bit of a knock knee, anything alignment is off, you will have the tendency to develop early arthritis. And most of this is genetic. So people say, what can I do? Can I eat turmeric? And like I used to sit and give it long, like, oh yeah, you know, there are studies that show it doesn't help. Now I tell them, yeah, go eat, do whatever you want. Because it's a hard thing to explain. And I also tell, like, my mom ate turmeric like all her life and she developed knee arthritis, right? So there is no, like, you can say, oh, I'm gonna eat this, it's gonna get better. The only preventative thing that we can do is just stay light, eat healthy, be flexible. Those are the three things that will prevent you and increase the longevity. Yoga is helpful. People, you know, not everybody can do yoga, but yoga for some reason is very helpful. And I was not doing yoga until like maybe 5 years ago. Now I don't do as much as I want to, but I do it, like, try to do it a couple times a month, because flexibility is very important. Strength training is important, flexibility is important. All the exercise in the proper ratio is very important. People say, oh, I work all day. I'm like, what you do? I stand in the kitchen and cook all day. That's really not work, because yes, it is work, but you're standing, but your body is not really working. It's not moving. So exercise is very important. So what are the treatment options for arthritis? So when the joint is worn out, or on the process of wearing, same analogy for a tire. Like, if your tire is wearing out, deal with it until you cannot deal with it. Like, you know, you have a little bit of a flat tire here and there, patch it up, keep running. At some point, it comes to a point that patching is not gonna work unless you put the car in the garage. Meaning, you stop walking, you stop doing your exercises, you sit and watch TV all day. If you're okay with that, then it's fine. So that's the same analogy. If you want to enhance longevity, you have to keep moving. So the body in motion stays in motion. So people who slow down, sit around, definitely develop all of the medical problems, your diabetes, your hypertension, everything goes up. So to control all that in a way, you have to be mobile. And I think joints are essential to do that. And you have to take care of them starting as early as probably 30 years old. Like, this fact people might not know, that the body deposits calcium in the body until you're about 30, 35, maybe not even 35, 30. After 30, the calcium repletes, meaning your bone is not getting stronger after 30, 35, it gets weaker. So all the deposits that happens in the early part of life. So you do have to exercise, eat healthy, and later part of life, you have to make sure that if you have to use it. I have people who are like walking on one leg for whatever reason, and you see their x-ray, the other side bone is like really ghost, so there's no bone left. So yeah, being active is very important. And now, so I'm just gonna say hip replacement, knee replacement, see if you can go to the next slide. Please, thank you. So is this an operation for elderly? I don't think so. It's not really an operation for elderly, but average age for joint replacements in my patient population is probably about 60. And it's getting younger and younger. So now if you're 85, it's a little bit on the older side, but people who are 85 who get routinely surgery, it's not, for a 90-year-old to do a knee replacement, I have to think 5 times. For a hip replacement, I would do it in a heartbeat because they do much better, quicker recovery. Knee replacement in a 90-year-old is pushing for it, unless the patient is in extremely good health. And you don't want to leave it till 90 years old. I mean, what is the point of that, right? Because you want to be active, you want to be, you know, you're in 70s, you don't want to sit around. So it's really not an operation for the elderly. It depends on where your arthritis level is and what, how bad it is. Go to the next slide, please. If we can find a video, if this video probably is not going to play. This guy is a patient of mine who is a 30-some-year-old guy who's a martial artist. He was a martial artist, and he could not do it anymore, and I fixed his hip like a few years ago, and he's an agent. Now he's coaches, and he does things. I mean, unfortunately, we can't play the video. Things he does is just amazes me. So he is only 30s, and it's his 30s, and this is not any form of strange arthritis or trauma. It is just regular arthritis. And if you can go to the next one. So this lady, probably not the right slide for this crowd, but just to point that she is 6 months out of a hip replacement, and this is what she does. She's a very respected person in the community, and she does shows in New York City. She was a Cirque du Soleil dancer before, and she does, and this is kind of unheard of after hip replacement surgery. So the younger and younger people are getting surgery. Now, I'm not saying that if you get a hip replacement, go do that. But if you are doing it before, most of the time people can return to their pre-surgery level. It depends. And I have patients who ski, who snowboard, and all kinds of stuff. So, and if you can go to the next one. So the point is, it's not really an operation for the elderly. It depends on how bad your arthritis is. Like I said, arthritis is, this is where it can happen. Anything that moves, you can have it. Can happen in the spine, hips, knees, hands. And if you keep going, please. And this is hand. This is every joint that moves can develop arthritis. Next. And this is the knees. This is what typically a normal knee looks like, a healthy knee. And the other side is what an arthritic knee looks like. It just looks terrible. But you got to really know what is terrible. So not does everybody need knee replacement or hip replacement for arthritis? No. There is a role, right? Like you have to manage things. So it's all about managing symptoms. Now, if you are functioning, you're playing your tennis, doing whatever, and you have very little pain, then you're fine. You can just do physical therapy, injections, and manage it. But I think the you got to be truthful to yourself. You got the question you have to ask is, am I really? You can't just tell yourself I'm active, right? And just walk 2 blocks and say I'm active. You got to be truthful to yourself. Am I doing everything I need to do that is making me happy? So that if I can't answer that question, only you guys can answer that question. Am I being truthful to myself? Can I do whatever I need to do? If I can, and within the reasonable amount of pain, yes, it's fine. And if not, then it's time to seek help. You know, people don't really like to seek help. I mean, honestly, I am also the same category. I don't have a primary doctor. I think it's time for me to get one. So it's terrible. But it is true. People take health for granted. You know, people would pay. I'm just going to give an example in India, what people do. The people would pay 3 crores for a 4 crores for a car, if I were to speak in Indian language. But to take care of their body, they would not like to spend a dime. They would pay 2 lakh rupees for a sari that they probably wear once a year. But they would not like to spend $1 on their body. It's just ingrained in the head and culture. That has to change because the most important thing for you is the body. It's not the sari or the gold. The brick that you guys have in the, especially Gujaratis, I'm sure you have a lot of gold stored in the basement. I don't know where you guys keep it, in the basement or. So you gotta invest on your body, either money, time, or mind, anything. So I'm also suspect culprit for that. I should find a medical doctor. And so physical therapy is the mainstay, and we can do injections. So you can go to the next slide, please. So bracing will help you. Sometimes people have knee. Bracing doesn't change the disease, but it will help you if you walk. If you want to walk, walking makes you happy for most people. And if you're having difficulties, put the brace on. And if you can walk around the block, and if that is helping you, yes, it's fine. Just continue with the brace on. But bracing doesn't itself change the disease, but it will help you to function, right? That's what, end of the day, what you need to do is function. And supplements like this, again, chondroitin, glucosamine, and turmeric, these are all not really well studied. Now, when people ask me, can I take glucosamine? Glucosamine is supposed to be for joint health. Is it, these things are not FDA approved, so if there's no control over it, again, like taking supplements, right? Athletic Green, I take this, I take that. There's no science to it, but if you take it, it's no wrong, nothing wrong with it. Is it going to magically change your life? Probably not, but if it psychologically gives you an advantage, sure, take it. But otherwise, I don't think it medically does too much in the doses we take them. Again, weight is very important, and I think for Gujarati population, I don't think weight is much of an issue compared to the rest of the population. So that's one thing I'm thankful for. As much as the Gujarati patients I operate on, I don't have to sweat during the surgery because I am not lifting 300-pound, 400-pound patients. So weight, again, is very important. So go to the next slide, please. So what does, who needs a knee replacement? Like a funny person, old patient, young patient? There's no really criteria for like age. Age does not really, in my mind, define criteria. But again, having said that, if I am doing a knee replacement on a patient who is under 50, I think three times because it does take time for them to feel better. A hip replacement, I would do 30, 40 in a heartbeat because they forget about it soon. The knees take longer. So when people say, done for the right reasons and done right, most patients do well. When people come and say, oh, my friend had knee replacement, he's still in pain. A lot of people complain. Like I have patients who come and say who had one surgery one side and once on the other knees one side. But people just sometimes naturally complain and they tell me, oh my God, my surgery, I had the side surgery is hurting. They're functioning fine, they're bending fine, there's no swelling. And then they say, oh, can I have a replacement on the left side? I'm like, why do you want to do that if you're complaining? And then they say, oh, this is hurting much more than that one. So people generally complain, but I think the attitude is important. You got to be positive about it, right? Like if you want to buy, if you buy a 2 lakh rupees, sorry, you're positive about it. You're happy about it. It has to be the same way. You can't like say, I'm going to do something and I'm not going to be mentally invested in it. You have to be mentally invested in it. You want to get better. You don't want to say, oh, I did the knee and let's see what happens. It's your knee. As much as it's my work, it's your knee. So you have to get better. So I think attitude is very important. So you have to have positive attitude, and you know, positive attitude never in life goes for everything. And I think this is just another thing. You have to be very positive about it and it will get better. To forget about a knee replacement, like I tell patients, takes easily 8-10 months to forget about it. Hips are much quicker, probably people forget about it in 3 months. Knees do take long, so you have to put in the work, and once it's done, it's set, you're fine. And then, so when people say, oh, I have my hip arthritis, that is not really hip pain, that is more muscular pain. Sometimes it could be coming from the back, so when people say that I have hip issue, that is really not hip. But for more common people, they do think that's hip, but that's really not a hip. It's just muscular pain or lower back pain that is radiating to that side. So this is kind of the incidence of osteoarthritis in the early part of post-industrial world, like, you know, 50, 100 years ago. Arthritis incidence was low because people used to squat to go to the toilet. And, you know, nowadays most people don't do that. But if you do that, and if you're not eating all the cheese and stuff, you're naturally healthy. Now, people don't do any of that. People don't take advantage of any of the squatting or doing anything. People are all industrialized nations. The exercise is, unless you go to the gym or do something, exercise or work is not inherently built into our routine. So that's why in the post-industrial world, all these things are creeping up. Medications is going up. Longevity is going up. That's not because the lifestyle is better. It's just because the medical care is better. Now, do you live a healthier, happier life than somebody living 100 years ago? I don't think so. We just live the same life, and what you make of life is up to yourself. But I think the arthritis rate is going up just because of the lifestyle. And this is just another study where they say that symptomatic arthritis in urban areas is much higher compared to the rural areas just by the virtue of lifestyle. And go to the next one, please. And again, knee replacement is much getting higher. The average age of knee replacement, okay, this is another staggering statistic. The people getting knee replacements in the when they're 55 has more than 5 times in the last 5 years compared to the rise of people who are in the 75 times, only doubled. But people who are in their 55s and above, it's like almost 10 times more joint replacements we're doing. It's just more and more people want to be active and I have a lot of people who are in their 60s want to ski and they want to play pickleball. Pickleball is another big headache actually. Pickleball season is getting out of hand, but the pickleball is a big driver for these people. Go to the next one, please. And like here, look, if we look here, like this is just slide, just top left. I mean, if you can't see from the back, the incidence of knee replacements go down after like 85, just because it's too much work. I'm like, why am I doing this? It's a lot of work. But the hip replacement does go up because it gives you a lot of mileage. So you don't want to live it till that long if you have bad hips or knees. But the prevalence of arthritis in general is going up, especially in the Indian population. Now we do robotics now, so I'm just putting a few lines about robotic. What robot? This is not the robot we use. This is just the robot that is in movies. And go down, please. What is robotic? Robotic is still evolving. It's very in infancy stage, but still there are a lot of pros and cons. I do all my knees robot. Hips, I do about 30% robot, just because the technology is still evolving. Unless there's a compelling reason for me to do a hip robot, I don't do hip robots because your incision is bigger. But the knee robotics, when I was a resident, it was coming out, and I used to say, oh my God, everybody has to get a CAT scan. It's such a waste. And if I tell you, if I want my knee done, I want it done precisely to the T. I don't want a guy who comes and smiles at me and asks me how you are, just do a good job. But every patient is different, right? People want somebody who is warm and welcoming and shake their hand and say, how you doing? And some people want a perfect technician. So what is the right balance for a doctor? I mean, that I don't know the answer to that question, but as I'm getting older, I see both sides and why both are important. Because when I was in 30, I don't care. Just do a good job. I don't want to see you. Just do a good job. But as you get older, you know, we live in a society. We need a doctor who is responsible. Now, he may not be the perfect technician he is, but he is there for me and he has his best interest. So it's a balance, and I'm all evolving with that too, right? You know, if, as a surgeon, I have to battle those questions like, what is my job? Is it just to fix you, or is it fix you and care for you personally? These are all evolving thoughts. But anyway, so robotics is here to stay. It's just like everything else. Do you build a building with your blueprint, paper and pencil, or do you build them in the computer? Simple, it's just here to stay. And it just makes the surgery all is precise. So robotic is not a new surgery. Robotic is a new way to do the surgery. It's the surgery of knee replacement is still an old pig. Robotic is just a lipstick on the old pig. It's not a new animal. It's the same thing, but it's just a little bit more precise. So unless something else changes in the next, maybe not in my lifetime, you know, that we do something else that does not need metal and plastic in the joints. But overall, I think the point of the matter is technology is here to stay. I think artificial intelligence, everybody hears about that, AI, that would be in a stage where one day you have knee arthritis, you put a CT scan in the computer, and then the computer will tell you, you need a knee replacement at 80% chance of doing this, and that. Those things are, that's going to be the future at some point when the computer is going to say what you should do. But I think the human element of somebody has to do it will always be there. So robotics, I think, is extremely, in my practice, I've been doing it for the last 4 or 5 years. That's kind of what the robot looks like. It's just a big box. Every other company is coming out with their iteration of robot. And this is what we look like. If you guys are curious, on the bottom right, that's how we kind of wear the spacesuit. just it's for sterility, just because we want to keep ourselves clean, not look cool or anything. It's just the way it is. Can go to the next slide, please. So again, I'm not going to go into the details. So robotics is kind of getting popular everywhere. Most newer surgeons do it. The reason why older guys who are good surgeons have problem is like any learning for anybody who is more than 50 takes time. I mean, even for me, it takes time, because if you're to understand new topic, yes, you get older, your processing speed goes down. So people don't want to do it, and then they bash about it. The other side of the truth too is anytime you take new technology, it's not like an iPhone, oh my God, there's a hitch, you know, you will send a new software upgrade. You can't do that. Once you do something in the body and it's wrong. There's no upgrade. So you got to be careful. That's why the medical technology evolves very, very slowly. And I think as a doctor, you have to balance what to adapt, what not to adapt. But otherwise, in general, robotic knee replacement is here to stay. And go to the next slide, please. So it's very precise. And like I tell people, knee replacement is still an art. It's a science to some extent, but most of it is art. The robot helps the scientific part of it, but the art part is not helped by the robot. You still need the surgeon to say what patient, how much tension you need the knee. You can't put the same knee who is like a 250-pound guy, 150 or 120-pound lady. They take different stress. So still, even though it's very much a science, there's still a lot of art involved in it, and also a lot of emotional part to, you know, help the patients. So I'm here to help, not just for surgery, you know, to get people going and make them happy and to some extent give their lifestyle back. So yeah, without just boring you guys too much with more lines of knee replacement, I'm going to answer some questions. If you guys have any questions, happy to take some questions.
Mike, check questions.
Excellent presentation, Dr. Boraiah. Just one simple question. Which exercise does more harm to the knees? Is it a treadmill? Should we go for an elliptical? Or do you have any recommendations?
Right. Anything that impact loading, meaning any exercise that leaves your feet on the platform, like elliptical, right? You're not putting your feet up. It's a little bit less impact loading. It's better. Biking, you know, you're not taking the foot off the ground, so it's better. It's called a closed chain exercise. So if your feet is on the ground all the time, biking, elliptical is better. Impact loading, like running, is slightly not better, but if you can do it, it's great. If you're just asking in terms of which is better, probably that's better. Elliptical and biking is better because your feet is planted on the ground. Huh? Treadmill is good, but again, if you're walking, it's treadmill as compared to doing nothing is absolutely better. But treadmill as compared to biking is also okay, but I would probably bike if you have a bike, and walking is fine. If you're running, well, that's a very hard question. What is treadmill better? Yes, treadmill is better. Walking is good, biking is also good. If you can run, you can run. But if you're hurting and you're running and your body is not in shape, you're going to get injuries. So don't push the limit, right? Even for athletes, people who push it always get injuries. So you stay within your comfort zone, slowly build up. If you push it, suddenly you're going to get injuries. And then you're going to take two steps back. I don't want you to fall down on the treadmill and get a call that, oh my God, I broke my hip. But take it slowly, yeah. Yeah, I mean, you can, and I think you should, because at some point you have to plow through the pain to keep it flexible. So sometimes, you know, the knees get stiff, sometimes the knees get swollen and the bending gets harder. But I think the more flexible you are, I think it will help you. If it's a lot of pain, I would back up. But I think if it's a little bit of pain, I think being flexible is really important. And quad strength increases the longevity. Your ability to do squats, sitting on the ground and standing up without help is an indicator of your longevity, how long well, whatever science, it's not perfect science, but yes, if you can sit on the ground and get up without any help, it says that you have some good years left in you. And also, people also say grip strength. So that's kind of also very poorly studied, but it's also well accepted. When you shake someone's hand, if you have good grip strength, again, it's an indicator of good health and longevity.
Dr. Boraiah.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you? Hello. I'm going to see you in 2 weeks in your operating theater.
Who fixed you?
My question is, I'm a little bit concerned because you said the knee replacement takes much longer to recover, and the pain and this exercise and physical therapy and all that. How to shorten this? Because I don't want to have months and months to recover.
That's a legitimate question. So I had a patient like last week who was 80, I think he's 80, he's a dentist. I saw him and he could squat down and get up 2 weeks after surgery. I was amazed. I was baffled. He's 80. And this is an Indian guy. I was shocked. That is not common. And he keeps telling me I have no pain and I can't believe it. And he wants to go back to work. Now, why it happens, I don't know. And some patients have more pain. Some of it is poorly understood. Why some people have more pain, why some people are perfectly running, ready to run. What you can do is just keep your strength active, you know, have good quad strength, good conditioning before you go into surgery, exercise, keep your knee bending, range of motion going, and I'll fix it, and then say a prayer to God. How long it lasts? I think the new bearings last a long time. I don't expect to redo it just because it's going to wear out. Now you can fall or something can happen, you get hit by a bus or something. Things can happen, but short of that, under normal circumstances, we don't expect it to wear. The new bearing, even if you're 50, I tell patients that I don't expect to redo this because it's not going to last because it's going to wear out now. Things can happen, but like, you know, your bone can get weak, you can get a fracture, but short of that, you know, there's no life, much longer life than before, yeah.
Yeah, I had my surgery 10 weeks back, and when I walk, I still show some limping. So how long does it take to go away?
Right. So again, if the limping comes from two reasons. One from pain and one from lack of strength. So if, like I tell people, it's not like buying a new car. You know, you buy a new car, you sit in the car, you look cool, you drive perfectly fine. Buying a new knee is not buying a new car. You still have to put in the work. The body has to get used to it. You have to do your work. If you have limped for a long time, it's probably, to forget about it, I said, to forget about knee replacement takes more than 6 months. Now, if you work at it, I think the limp will go away. But if you're only 10 weeks out, you're 2.5 months, you probably need another, I don't know, I haven't, probably another couple of months.
Okay.
Swelling?
Oh, yeah. Is
there
any?
I'm happy to see you, but I think the new knees we put in is called press-fit knees. They're not cemented, meaning the bone has to grow into the components, and they take slightly longer for the swelling to go down. Before, we used to do cemented knees. The cement bonding, as time goes by, weakens, but the new knees we put in are press-fit knees. The bond strengthens over the time, so it takes a little bit longer, about three, four months, for the knee to completely settle down.
Yeah.
It does not.
Any
right. It does not matter in the long run. Anesthesia type, I could do it in the kitchen, new kitchen probably, but most of the time we do it under spinal, just because it's quicker recovery, it doesn't suppress your immunity. For all I could know, technically from my point of view, I could do it in your kitchen table and you'll still be fine. But from the short term point of view, spinal is better.
Surgery is
is bone surgery is painful. I don't think anesthesia has anything to do with what happens after 48 hours. No. Right. So that's why we do all of these under spinal. Right. Right.
And I tell the surgeon that if the patient, you know, says that I want that removed, tell us no.
Right. We don't do that. Right. We send people home in 8 hours, not 8 days. And we don't leave catheters in. The reason people leave catheters is, yes, it will make you totally pain-free, but spinal catheter, epidural catheters is also a risk of infection. We want, the pain is going to happen. Now, if you leave a catheter for 8 days, you pull the catheter out after 8 days, the pain is going to be there. So now you might as well bite the bullet. So the current standards, nobody leaves a catheter, but my mom did have an epidural catheter in India, and that's exactly what you're talking about. The reason people do that, okay, now if you're going to ask me that question, I'll tell you. People in India do that, leave epidural catheters, because if you have a catheter, you have to stay in the hospital. Sometimes you can go home, but if you want, if you're a private hospital and you want to keep them 4 days and 5 days, and you can do that, but in this day and age, a lot of healthcare is also driven by economics, without compromising the quality. But from, if I'm a patient, I want to be quick spinal, which lasts 2 hours. That's it, no epidural, none of that, and I want to be home in 8 hours. The best recovery happens at home. The pain is going to happen, but I think these things are all well controlled. Spinal anesthesia is what we use. I think kind of you're alluding to that, but we don't use epidural. There's too much risk.
The reason I
ask
the question is, I was anesthesiologist at the Delta Hospital. And the surgeon said, when I was there in the first year, 100% of the
Right. So I guess a little bit has changed since.
In the second year, there were, I heard that, you know, because the patient could not be ambulated well without pain.
Right.
They did not want to stand and walk.
Right. But most days we do them, we send them home now. They walk them. If I could, I would make them walk out of the operating room. Right. Right, I think those days are gone, I would say. Right. True, right. It's no question it will help with the pain, but I think things have evolved a little bit, so yeah.
Hello. It's very easy to understand your speech. Very easy to understand, but I want to ask one question, which is better, robotic surgery or normal surgery, and why? What is the difference between two surgeries?
Well, a good surgeon is going to do a good job, regardless of a robot or not. For a bad surgeon, the robot helps more than it helps a good surgeon. The robot helps both surgeons. For the good surgeon, it might help a little bit. For a bad surgeon, it might help more. Somebody who is not as good as somebody who's bad like me, it will help more. So so I would do the robot. It depends on the surgeon. If you have a good surgeon and if you don't have access to the robot, there's nothing wrong with going with that surgeon. But if you have a seasoned robotic surgeon, that's who you really want. You don't want a new guy trying a new robot on you, but you want a seasoned guy who is perfectly capable of doing both. And robot is just a tool, like I said.
It is less painful or fast recovery?
Slightly less painful because the dissection is slightly less and it's more precise, slightly less painful. Not night and day difference, but slightly better, yeah, in terms of pain. Expense, no, free. For Gujaratis, it's definitely free.
Thank you. question. I'm just little limping, but at night I walk 2 miles, but at night I have no pain or nothing. So never take the Tylenol or Advil. So do I have to surgery?
Looks like you're doing pretty good, so I don't think so. But you can get checked up just to see where you're at. But I don't think so. It doesn't sound like you need anything. Yeah, some people take injection for, right. So if your knee, like I said, if your tire is worn out, you know, getting flat tires here and there, injections will help you keep it running. If it's not bad enough, at some point it will stop working. And that's when you know, okay, this is not working. It's time to change the tire.
Now, among the cortisol and the PRP and the prolotherapy, you have any comments?
Right. So PRP is really not approved by insurance. You have to pay out of pocket. I don't think it does too much for knee arthritis. If you're an athlete, you know, you need a slight edge. You can do PRP and stuff, but it's really not a known treatment for arthritis. Now, if you have a lot of money to burn, you can get a PRP. But gel injections are also there. The academy does not support the gel. People say gel injection, I want it. It's some insurance don't cover it. It's very hard because some people love it. So now, even though our academy, our surgeons academy does not support it, some people love it, so there's no harm in it. So we do it all the time. And some people feel better. That's a little different. Gel is just like hyaluronic acid. Yeah. Yeah, that's what is it? Symbis. Yeah. Yeah, that's the gel injection I'm talking about. The academy does not advocate gel, American Academy, because if you give a treatment, right, if you take 100 people and give them orange juice, right, and if you ask, that's not a good analogy, if you give 100 people like some bad tasting orange juice, right, something, some people will say it's still good. Now, regardless of that, now you don't really know. If you give some people, say, water and tell them this is, yeah, and some people will believe it. So now it's hard to say if 50% of the people it helps and 50% of the times it doesn't help. It's really hard to know, is it really the drug or the patient psychology? So it's hard, but that's why the academy does not recommend it. But if in my practice, if 50% of the people are loving it and patients want it and the insurance company approves it, there's nothing wrong in giving it. You might be better. I don't know the answer. If you ask me personally, does a Symbis gel injection make my knee better? Answer is, it might. There is no harm in it. You can try. Now, if you ask me, are you going to put $100,000 to tell me that my knee is going to get better after Symbis? I would not do it. Yeah. Right, cortisone in general, people who take prednisone for whatever asthma or anything, will definitely make your bone density go down. But the injection doses are pretty low and they go local. So it does not change your bone density or anything. If your knee is developing arthritis, people getting cortisone, they say, cortisone made my knee worse. It's really not the cortisone that made your knee worse. You're probably getting worse anyway, and cortisone happened to be there. But in general, cortisone, prednisone does reduce your bone density. But the low dose injections we give has absolutely no bearing with it.
Yeah, one.
Right. They also increase the weight if you take it systemic, like tablets. But the injection dose doesn't. Injection dose is, if you take 3 injections a year, it's very, very low dose. And you can't blame that for your weight. Sorry.
Yeah, at Northwell, the knee replacement surgery is done in the facility or the AMSURG?
Both places? Yeah.
So
yeah.
Which one is better, the hospital or?
I mean, I also do this at a private ambi center in Melville, but it's all the same. To do it at an ambi center, you have to qualify. We have certain criteria. Okay. Now, if I tell a patient to get up and go, if it takes 5 minutes to get up and walk to their door, I'm not going to do him at an ambi because it doesn't qualify.
I see, because sometimes insurance company pushes patient to go for the MSURG.
Right, insurance companies now pushes everybody to get outpatient surgery, because outpatient surgery cost for inpatient, I'm not going to give you the numbers and stuff, but outpatient cost for insurance companies is half the inpatient's cost for the surgery. But from the surgical point of view, you get the same part, you get the same lubricant, you get the same surgeon. Just the care.
Who decides? Okay, doctor has to decide whether the patient has to go for ambulatory or hospital?
I decide most of the time, yeah. Yes.
Thank you.
Once you have a surgery, what periodically checking should be done?
My practice is I see the patients at 2 weeks after surgery, 3 months and 1 year. It depends on the surgeon. Some people see them every 3 months. I don't see any value in it. Unless there's something wrong, obviously they come back. Otherwise, 2 weeks. 2 weeks, 3 months, and 1 year. And most patients after 6 months don't show up. The only ones that show up are having some problems, but most of them don't show up. Yeah.
How about the Mako producer for surgery?
Right, that is what we're talking about. That is what the Mako is, that's what it looks like. There's a 3D model of the knee. That is one. Huh? It's new, yeah, it's not. It's newish, like 5-6 years old for near, maybe 8-7 years old. That's kind of new for medical, in the medical field, yeah. It's not brand new like 6 months. You don't wanna something in your knee that is brand new like 6 months old, because it might be recalled. Right. Yeah.
Do you have a sample here?
Sample, I do have, I leave it here. I have a sample here, I leave it here. It's in my bag. It's what kind of looks like. I'm just gonna leave it here. You guys can keep it in the society. Okay. So there are a few parts in the knee replacement. So there's that bone. This part that goes on the femur bone is cobalt and chromium. The part that goes on this bone, the tibia bone, is titanium. And the bearing is a high density polyethylene. That's standard for knee replacements. Hip implants are all titanium. Not in the hips, there is ceramic ball, not in the knees. Some European countries do ceramic bearing, not in the United States. It's for knees, it's not advocated. Hips, all ceramics, yeah.
She would like to ask the question in Hindi.
Yeah.
My operation 20 years in India. She tells me.
Okay. Parts के वजह से नहीं हो रहा है पर अब शायद muscles के वजह से हो रहा है. I mean, if I have to really assess it, I have to look at the X-ray. Yeah. अगर आपके knee replacement नहीं भी होते हैं तो ऐसे बहुत सारे लोग होते हैं जो अगर उठते हैं तो थोड़ा shake होते हैं. तो इसको knee replacement से कुछ लेना देना नहीं, शायद आपके मसल से पर हाँ बाकी यप नो प्रॉब्लम ओके आई थिंक लास्ट वन या श्योर Actually, it's in my car. Let me bring it. I'll give you now. You want to come? I do about 300-400 a year. Just knees. Yeah, robotic. Huh? I know. I don't know. I wish I could give it in my car. Yeah, about 300-400 a year, yeah.
When you say me, for appointment.
I don't know. I'll check with her.
Call his office, call his office, please.
Yeah.
No appointments here.
So just one second, please. Yeah. If you're taking Boniva, yeah. It does not affect anything. Yeah, it doesn't change anything. Boniva is bone health, it's not for joints, it doesn't change anything. It's just for osteoporosis, it's fine. Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. Okay, if anybody wants something, I have it in the car. I'll give you injection.
મારી યાદદાસ્તમાં જ્યાં સુધી છે ત્યાં સુધી કદી કોઈ લેક્ચરમાં આટલા બધા ઇન્ટરેસ્ટિંગ સવાલ અને આવા પ્રિસાઇસ આન્સર્સ મળ્યા નથી. સો ઇટ અપીયર્સ ઇફ યસ ટાઈમ and if he permits more question, it will be an endless session. So if there is any important question left, we will request him to stay for 5 more minutes. But otherwise, now the type of question which was asked last by Usha Ben, please avoid that. It's purely personal. Okay, is there anybody who is having any other question? Otherwise, I will request Mukund Bhai to summarize something for the talk. Mukund Bhai. There is one more question by
not about
Maya Ben. Yes.
Mike.
My question is, I know we are all talking about osteoporosis, which is very common in Indian ladies. But preventive aspect, I mean, it's not just your field or your specialty, but not paid enough attention to that. Now the treatments are available, hyperphosphonate and all that.
Right, so a question is osteoporosis, what can we do? There are a lot of treatments. It's really not my area, but I'll tell my take on it. Now I can tell you to go and run and jump and exercise, right? Because that is probably the best way you build the bone. But I think that ship has sailed for most people. So for you, what you can do is walking. You have to keep active. You can take bisphosphonates, like you said, Boniva or Fosamax. They all have side effects. So now if you take Fosamax for 5-6 years, it causes issues. So you need a good endocrinologist. But there are, like, try take less tablets as much as you can, because preventative health is much more important than taking treatment for hypertension. It's not like, oh, I take a blood pressure tablet and I think I'm good. But the real key is to be active. But now I can't tell you guys to go and run and jump. And you know, at this stage, yes, it is still active. Number one is active health exercise. Number two is medication. Yeah, Boniva, you could take Fosamax. And just really not my area of expertise, but I think definitely that those things help. There's parathyroid injections, PTH injections, they all increase your bone density. Yeah, you can take, it's not monthly, it's mostly daily tablets, it's calcium. Yeah, monthly once, huh?
Calcium is daily.
You can take it in whichever form you want. It's like you go to the temple every day or once a month. But yeah, if you can, you can do whatever you want. But that's, you can take a little bit more than that. It could be something else. Yeah.
Away. Ultimately, we will have to end the session, and I will request Mukund Bhai.
Thank you very much, Doctor. You have given a very nice presentation. It was an excellent subject. I think the entire lecture was informative and educative. When we came here, before he started the lecture, we had so many questions in our mind. But he has really clarified, to the best of his ability, all the nuances he has covered. So, doctor, you have covered the whole 9 years on the subject. So, we are very thankful to you for your remarkable time. I know you are extremely busy, and when you somebody approaches, one gets the appointment only after 6 weeks or so, generally. So, I think his time is very important, and we are really lucky to have him here today. And also, Pankaj Bhai, when he visited and when he said, will you please come, and he instantly agreed. That was shows your really dedication to the society and the community. And also Dr. Shyam Bhai Ra for bringing him here. So thank you very much once again. See you again. Thank you.
Thank you, Mukund Bhai. Dr. Shyam Rao, our Vice President of Public Relations, who tried the liaison with the doctor and brought him here. I would request him if he wants to say something. One of the good things today was there were a lot of questions from the doctors. And some of the answers I hope the doctors understood. General public did not. It was in a medical parlance, so that was the case. Once again, doctor, thank you very much. Actually, when I asked him whether you can come for a lecture, I was almost 90% sure he will say no, he is too busy. And that has been my experience with many other doctors. When such a busy doctor, when I ask that whether you can, they will, on one pretext or the another, they will say no, they cannot. So, it was a pleasant surprise from me when he readily agreed. Thank you very much. I thought Pakaji is going to be here. You want to leave? Oh, okay. We have the presence of Pakaji, the president of Gujarati Samaj, with us. Which is also not that all the time he is able to attend our program, but when he is here, we would like to hear something about the community, something about our activity, their activity. So, Pakaji, please.
Thank you very much, Indo-American Senior Citizen Center, President, Chairman, all members. Thank you. Dr. Boraiah, you have done my both knees. And it worked out so good. Thank you again. The first day, the right knee, when you did it, I was walking in 11th day. I draw a car. In my left knee, I draw a car in 3rd day. But then it is a little complication because then I have pain. But it worked out good. Today, I'm here in Indo-American Senior Citizen Center, and this center is supported by India Home. So, Vatsalaji, thank you very much for combining two organizations together. And we would love to come to Jamaat Samaj too. And I would like you to all guys invite in Gujarati Samaj, and we have to be united. At one point, we should do major events together. So that is my humble request to all our leaders that let's get together once in a while and we do couple, at least not two, three, at least two, three or four events together at this year. And then in the future, we might do more. So I would like help from all our organizations, and I'm ready from my side too. Again, thank you. And tomorrow we have a parade and I'm a grand marshal.
Yes.
So if you guys want to see me on there, please come and enjoy. And I would like to invite everybody to be there. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Pakaji. તમને બધાને ખબર હશે છેલ્લા એક વર્ષથી ગુજરાતી સમાજે એમના તમામ કાર્યક્રમો બધા જ મેમ્બર્સ માટે ફ્રી કર્યા છે વિધાઉટ ચાર્જિંગ એનીથિંગ. I don't think it has ever happened in Gujarati Samaj. This is for the first year that entire year all the programs were free for all the members. So thank you, Pakaji. Now, today's program, as we have announced, is sponsored by India Home and Dr. Vasudhara Kalaspudi, who is the executive director of India Home. She is with us. India Home is helping seniors in many ways. Some of the people who do not have even any insurance or they are not legal, for them also they are finding ways to help them. So what they do for seniors, how we can take the advantage, I will request Dr. Vasudhara Kalaspudi to talk about that. Vasudhara ji.
Thank you very much. In fact, our president Mukunji is here, and of course, as Pakaji says, we all have to come together. This is the time that we should forget about where we come from. We come here as an immigrants into this country. So we have to, there is nothing wrong in taking the government help, not only our community help, government help also, because this program, NYC Care, I know most of you have insurances, but if you have your friends, children, or anybody else coming to this country as students, they may not have insurance. You can tell them to contact India Home, we'll distribute the flyers. You can give it to them, they can contact India Home staff member, they can help them. Whether they are on student visa, even if they are not on any visa, if somebody is coming and cleaning your house, that person doesn't have any legal status, still they are eligible because it's New York City. New York City helps a lot, because especially when it comes to health. And in addition to all those things, we also wanted to make a commitment to Indo-American Senior Citizen Centers members, as we request you to be members of India Home. It's a free membership. You don't have to pay anything. Just give your name and your email and your address. That is good enough, your phone number to contact you. And we wanted to make sure, like, because all of you, most of you have paid taxes in this country. There is nothing wrong in taking the government grants and having the programs like this, whether it is sponsoring the space or food or for any activities. In fact, one of the things which we mentioned before is a Broadway shows. So next in September, we have 2 weeks of Broadway week, where we get the subsidized tickets on the Broadway, but at the same time, India Home wanted to subsidize some more. Like, for example, Aladdin tickets. Believe me, like last week when my grandkids came, I saw the Aladdin for buying $200 a ticket. But now we wanted to give it $100 a ticket. And also, if it is a balcony, if it is a orchestra, it's $100. If it is a balcony, which is a little higher, that is $60. Because we could not only in addition to the Broadway subsidizing, we are also subsidizing some more. We will send the information to Jagdishji, and you can distribute. Please register. At the same time, contact the staff members. If you are not a member, just tell the staff member that I want to become a member, that's fine. And also, not only Aladdin, we are also wanted to do for the Lion King too. Lion King is a little bit more expensive when compared to Aladdin, but definitely our goal is to make it as minimal as possible so that some India Home would pay. We are registering, you have to register on 9th, September 9th and September 16th, and 2 o'clock show. Intentionally, we made it 2 o'clock show because for seniors, it's easy to go in the daytime to Manhattan and come back. At the same time, our tickets, we are trying to limit as 2 tickets per person, either you and your spouse, or if you want to bring your family member, either a grandson or your child, anyone, just tell them, like, because we wanted this kind of activities, we'll realize the kid cannot get that price. It is only because of the grandparent. So we want to have the added value of having grandparents buying these tickets for the children and for the families. So that is one of the things. Of course, the tickets are limited. So we put the deadline as September 1st, so that once you commit on September 1st, we'll buy the tickets. We will also send our staff members and volunteers as chaperones, you know, like for each batch of seniors, at least two chaperones, one will be staff member, one will be volunteer, will be there to help them out if there is anything else. And from once you go to Manhattan, you can have fun too. You know, after the Broadway show, you can go for a restaurant and eat something and, you know, have fun with your friends. That's one of the things. Other thing what we wanted to do is also, instead of, I know you're all coming, you're nicely coming to all the way to Jamaica, which is very far away for most of you. So we wanted to see if we can do in this neighborhood, either this part or the, yeah. Nassau County, weekly once, just like other centers, we operate in temples. We are looking in spaces, you know, which is reasonable and where we can do every Monday or, you know, depending on when the space is available. Hopefully, we are hoping by next month, we can come to a conclusion. And the programs also, definitely, you are doing excellent programs, like, for example, these talks and all. We would also continue those things, but at the same time, if you want anything special, extra programs, whether it is Tai Chi or something, we can get consultants and do the program for you. So no matter what it is, it should suit your needs and not only that, your taste. Because what we do in Jamaica, that doesn't mean that we have to replicate the same thing here. What you need, what you want, that's what we are here for. Yeah, and Kavita, you know Kavita. Kavita will be organizing this entire thing. So you can definitely communicate with Kavita whatever you want. She'll make sure it will happen. But it is our commitment to serve our senior community. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
You can mention about the flyer at the back?
Yes. The flyer, the NYC Care flyer, actually we are going to distribute it. I know most of you have insurances, but if you know anybody, whether the person is working in your house or in your business or students, for example, you can tell them. You can tell them. As the only requirement is that whoever needs the insurance, they have to be in 5 boroughs of New York City because it is a city program. And also, one more thing, I think you might have remembered, I mentioned about the co-living home in Floral Park. So we will be starting the co-living home. And after hearing the lecture, I was also convinced. I was thinking of getting an elliptical and a bicycle in the co-living home. It is not just for the seniors who are living there. If you wanted to go there and spend some time with the seniors who are living there, you can also use those bike and you know, elliptical and all that. So our idea is as much as possible to you know, serve the seniors here and in Nassau County also. Yes, yeah. One more thing. You know, by sponsoring all these things, you don't have to pay, right? You don't have to pay whether it is $10 or $15. But at the same time, you know, those who can afford or who wanted to say that this is important, India Home is doing, you wanted to support India Home, you can support it by donating. I know most of you have been supporting India Home, definitely. But we are having a fundraising gala on October 22nd. And in fact, one important thing is we are honoring our own president, Mukunji, and also Gujarati Samaj president, Kakaji. Both of them are going to be honored for their community services, what they have been doing all these years. And we didn't do any fundraising in the last 4 or 5 years because of COVID, but now we are doing it. I would request all of you, please support that. Because government gives money to India Home, but government also asks us, what did you raise from your community? Did you raise, for example, we got $2 million from Congress funding this year. One is Gregory Meeks gave $500,000, and also Chuck Schumer and Christine Gillibrand, they also gave $1.5 million, $2 million total, right? But at the same time, they want to see, because they're coming to our fundraising, they want to see, okay, is community supporting you or not? I mean, we cannot have, like, you know, say that, oh, 10, 20 people are there. We want to have 200, 300 people. It is going to be fun. And definitely, you know, I would request all of you to support that. We will distribute, we will distribute the flyer through your WhatsApp group. Yeah, yeah. But please, whatever you can support. You don't have to limit just for $200 or something. If you can do 2,000, 5,000, 10,000, please do it. Thank you. Yeah, when the purpose of having weekly once center is, you know, we can have not only programs, our case management staff, like our social worker, case manager, will come here and find out whether you need transportation or you need anything regarding your health insurance, or if you need to access any public health benefits, whether it is in Nassau County or Queens, anywhere, or in the city, they will help you. They can help you not only doing the applications, if need be, they can take you to the offices, government offices too. Our staff are very committed that way. So the case management would be a major advantage, especially when you are thinking about going for knee surgery and all these things. You know, sometimes you need, you are eligible for to get the transportation. And in fact, many times I admired Mukunji, because whenever I offered him, can I drop you, sir? He says, no, you are busy and I have my transportation. Because he booked his car already. So they, you are eligible for those, some of the benefits. So please access the benefits. There is nothing wrong, because all of us, we pay taxes. We are still paying taxes, right? It is, in my mother tongue, there is a saying, Adagande ammaina pettadu. If you don't ask, your mother won't feed you, right? You have to ask the government. You have to tell the government, this is what we need. This is what we need. Our seniors need this. Our community need this. So please don't hesitate. I mean, there is nothing wrong. It's not about having money. You can have $1 million. I know most of you must be living in $1 million homes. You know why you are coming here? Socialization. Socialization is extremely important. That's why you are coming here for more than 25 years. And socialization is important, not only just for emotional health, even for physical health also. Because when you have a friend, you feel like walking. When you have a friend, you feel like going somewhere and, you know, whether it is beach or park or anywhere, you want to enjoy that. To enjoy that, you need company, right? And another thing, what the doctor was also mentioning, why people are getting discharged much faster, there are two reasons. One, hospital rate infections are higher. The more you stay in the hospital, you tend to get hospital-transmitted infection. So people wanted to avoid that, whether it is insurance company or doctors or hospitals. So they are trying their best to discharge the patients on the same day or at the most next day or 2 days, depending on what kind of surgeries or what kind of procedures, what kind of health problems you have. And not only that, in America, actually, they are changing some of the policies. Because one of my friend, when she got admitted at Duke University ICU, they kept a bed for the patient, for her husband also. So literally, they are allowing family members and friends to stay in the ICU. Before, to enter the ICU, you need permission for five minutes or 10 minutes visit. But now, they wanted family members, so recovery is much faster. Right? When you go home, actually you walk much faster after the knee surgery. Because, and not only that, imagine you stay in the hospital for 1 week, what will happen? Nobody will pay attention. You need to go to bathroom. The nurse won't come and nobody will help you. You get frustrated. But at home, you have family members to help you. So it is always important to make sure, like, the medicine is changing. What I studied like 30 years back, it has changed totally. So don't worry when doctors are saying, oh, 8 hours you are going home. Be happy that you are going home. In fact, that's one thing I like with this doctor. Not only that, he is not pushing for medications. Because all medications, of course, we are trained to prescribe medications as doctors. But all medications have side effects. So whether it is short term or long term. So as much as possible, preventive health is more important, whether it is your physical exercise or whatever you wanted to do. So these are the things. But whatever you want, I know India Home does many things, so I keep forgetting. But as you are, I mean, as you get to know the organization, you can request any kind, or if you have any idea, like India Home should do this, please tell us. We will try our best to do that. Thank you. And one important thing I have to mention before I finish. When Mukunji joined our board, you know, how I was so much impressed with him, because when we advertised for board members, that advertisement has gone into some websites where only young people will see that, not old people. In fact, I didn't even know where we advertised, but Mukunji applied for it. Yes, sir.
Can we visit the India House anytime?
Anytime, sir. Yes.
Just for the information.
Sure, sir. Anytime. We have 3 days. Our main office is in Jamaica Estates, and 3 days we have dementia day program over there. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and Friday we have senior center. Even on the weekend we have program. Like this morning we have intergenerational technology program, and tomorrow 2 sessions of creative arts. One in the morning, one in the evening. So please, it's our goal is to open India Home, like all how temples are open. So we want to open it 7 days. Yeah, that's why we have staff members working in the weekends, and we have volunteer doctors also coming and helping us in the weekends. Yes, sir.
Personally, if we want some guidance regarding social security benefits,
yes.
After retirement benefits. Yeah.
Yes. Samra is our social worker, social work director. She is very good. If need be, if somebody, a senior, cannot come to our center, she has no problem going and visit the senior at home. She will drive, she will visit the senior, find out what exactly is needed. And in fact, the way she helped beyond limit, like one of our members actually, he received a bill for $10,000 because his father-in-law had to go to a hospital in Westchester. So she took care. She said, don't pay the bill. Give me. I will talk to them. I'll make sure like a very minimal payment, not $10,000. So our staff members are really resourceful in helping.
The timing is Monday to Friday?
Monday to Friday, they'll be there. But we can give the social workers, you can come anytime and meet her. And also any staff member you can reach out. You can reach out to Kavita or anybody, and definitely they will make sure like you get the help, sir. Thank you.
I think there can be hardly any other organization like India Home which renders so many types of free services, and the staff members, we don't consider them as staff. They are all as if they are the family members, and they work so willingly. That means it's really helpful. Thank you.
We all feel so lucky to have close association with India Home. India Home has paid staff members, experts. They are service oriented, and members of Indo-American can also take all the advantage of India Home. Okay.
Always smiling.
Thank you.
Okay. Now let us go into second part of the program. As I mentioned, after every value-based program, we try to have little entertainment also. And today, our own members, 3 of them at least are here, who are going to entertain us with their very melodious music. We have with us today the president of Adhyatmik Vikas Kendra. About him, that is Parag Bhai Patel, and I will request our president Jagdish Bhai to introduce him, and then he will entertain us.
Parag Bhai ne tadhi bada orakta jese Jalaram Satsang Parivar ma pan join thayela chhe Adhyatmik Kendra ma jare diabetes ne nimuk કરવાની હતી પ્રેસિડેન્ટ તરીકે તો એમની નજર સીધી પરાગભાઈ ઉપર જ ગઈ, કારણ કે ઘણા ટાઈમથી એક્ટિવ હતા પરાગ, અને બહુ ધાર્મિક પર્સન છે, અને મારા તો જીમના પાર્ટનર છે, એટલે એવરી મોર્નિંગ વી આર મંડે ટુ ફ્રાઈડે. પરાગભાઈ તમારો ટાઈમ, કારણ કે એમને 4 વાગે એમને બીજે ભજનમાં જવાનું છે, એટલે પહેલો ચાન્સ એમને આપી દે. પરાગભાઈ પ્લીઝ કમ.
Thank you.
Hello, hello. Hello.
Krishna Kanayalal ki jai, Swami Narayan Bhagavan ki jai, Adhyatmik Vikas Kendra ni jai. હું અને મારું આ બે શબ્દોમાંથી આપણે દૂર રહી અને એ બંને શબ્દોના સમન્વય રૂપી અમારું એટલે કે આપણું બધાનું સમજી કોઈ પણ કાર્ય કરીએ એમાં સફળતા મળે. જે પકાજી કરવા જઈ રહ્યા છે બધી સંસ્થાઓને ભેગા કરીને અને બધા જ પ્રોગ્રામો એક એક કરવા, એમનો જે અથાગ પ્રયત્ન છે એ બધામાં આપણે સપોર્ટ કરી અને એમને સફળતા બનાવીએ એ આપણી જવાબદારી બની પડે છે. થેન્ક યુ પકાજી, તમે આવું સમાજ માટે વિચારી છે, સોસાયટી માટે તમે બહુ જ ઘણા પ્રયત્નો કરો છો, એમાં આ અદમ્ય પ્રણામ પ્રયાસ છે, એના માટે ખૂબ ખૂબ આભાર. આપણે આજે અદમ્ય કારણ કરવાની વાત કરીએ, એવું જ એક ઉત્તમ ઉદાહરણ હમણાં 23 ઓગસ્ટ 2023 રોજ સાંજે 6 વાગે ભારતે વિશ્વ વિક્રમી કાર્ય ચંદ્રયાનની ચંદ્ર ઉપર સફળ ઉતરાણ કર્યું અને એ ચંદ્ર ઉપર પગ મૂકવાનું ચોથા દેશ તરીકે તથા સાઉથ પોલ ઉપર પગ મૂકવાનું સૌ પ્રથમ દેશ બન્યો. એ બદલ આપણે સૌ ભારતીયોને ખૂબ ખૂબ અભિનંદન. વૈજ્ઞાનિકો અને સમયસર નિર્ણયો કરનાર સરકારને પણ ખૂબ ખૂબ ધન્યવાદ કે જેના ચંદ્રયાનને પ્રથમ જે પગ મૂક્યો એવા વૈજ્ઞાનિકોને પણ ખૂબ ખૂબ ધન્યવાદ. તેના નામ પણ આપણે મોદી સાહેબે ગઈકાલે જ ડિસ્પ્યુટ કરી દીધા કે જ્યાં ચંદ્રયાન આ વખતનું ત્રણ વિતરું ત્યાં એનું નામ આપ્યું શિવશક્તિ, શિખ શક્તિ પોઈન્ટ. પહેલાં તો વિક્રમ હતું જ અને પાછું બીજું જે ચંદ્રયાન બે ઉતર્યું હતું ત્યાં કણી તિરંગા નામ આપ્યું એમણે. એટલે પણ એ પણ આપણા દેશના ગૌરવને લેવાની વાત છે. તો એક થોડુંક એના વિશે એક પંકજભાઈએ કાલે મને ઇન્સ્પાયર કર્યો કે ભાઈ કંઈક ચંદ્રયાન વિશે થોડોક શ્લોક બનાવજો, સાખી બનાવજો. તો રાત્રે 2 વાગ્યા સુધી પણ મતીને મેં તમને આ સાખી બનાવી રાખી છે. હે હે ધન્ય ધન્ય ભૂમિ ભારતની, અને જ્યાં જન્મ ધરે સંતો ભક્તો વૈજ્ઞાનિકો, રજણ ડંકો દીધો ચંદ્ર ભૂમિ પર, સૌથી પહેલા સાઉથ પોલ પર પગ મૂકીને વિક્રમ સર્જ્યો આવા વિરલા વૈજ્ઞાનિકો, એનો ઘણી કમાય અમને સો સો સલામ. જગદીશભાઈ મારું ઇન્ટ્રોડ્યુશન આપી દીધું પણ હું મારી સંસ્થાનું થોડું આપણી મારી નહીં પણ આપણી સંસ્થાનું પણ થોડુંક ઇન્ટ્રોડ્યુશન આપી અને પછી થોડુંક એન્ટરટેનમેન્ટ કરું પંકજભાઈ આપની પરવાનગી હોય તો. હું પરાગ પટેલ આધ્યાત્મિક વિકાસ કેન્દ્રમાં ડાયાબી પટેલના અનુગામી તરીકે સેવા આપું છું. સૌ હરિભક્તો અને બધી સંસ્થાઓના સહકારથી સફળતાપૂર્વક એ સેવા અને અમારી કમિટીના સહકારથી એ સેવા નિભાવી શકું છું. આપ સૌ વિદિત જ છો કે આધ્યાત્મિક વિકાસ કેન્દ્ર એ સંસ્થા પોતાના કોઈ પણ ચાર્જ ફી લીધા સિવાય ધાર્મિક, સામાજિક તથા આધ્યાત્મિક હિન્દુ ધર્મના પર્વોની ઉજવણી કરીને સંસ્કૃતિ અને આપણા ભારત ભૂમિની પ્રણાલીઓને જીવંત રાખવાનો પ્રયત્ન કરીએ છીએ. આધ્યાત્મિક વિકાસની ખાસ વિશેષતાઓમાં તો દર શુક્રવારે 48 વર્ષથી નોન સ્ટોપ અવિરતપણે 8:30 થી 10:30 ઘરે ઘરે જઈ અને ભજન કરવા, ઇવન કોવિડ વખતે પણ જૂમ ઉપર પણ આપણે ભજન ચાલુ રાખેલા, તથા પિકનિક, નવરાત્રિ, અન્નકૂટ, તુલસી વિવાહ, ગાયત્રી યજ્ઞ, શિવ પૂજા વગેરે વગેરે પર્વોની ઉજવણી કરતા જે કોઈ દાન મળે છે એ દાન ભારતમાં અથવા તો યુએસએમાં જરૂરિયાતવાળાઓને પૂરી પાડી અને આપણે પહોંચાડી અને એ પુણ્ય કમાવાની સેવા આપીએ છીએ. ધન્યવાદ. આજે મને રુદ્રાક્ષ કટમ સંભળાવવાનો લાભ આપ્યો છે. Thank you.
Thank you. bhajante haloke pareva narayanam natavad sukham shanti samitapanasam prasida prabho sarva bhuta Jānāmi yogam japam naiva pūjām natuham sadā sarvadāsyām bhutubhyām jarājanma dukho jatātabhyamānam prabhu pāhiyāpān namāsī sashambho वैजनाथ महादेव की जय।
मोर पिछाड़ा श्याम छोगाड़ा गोप गोवाड़ा नंद लाला दलाला दीन दयाड़ा कृपाला रूप रसाला मतवाला ते चितड़ू चोरी मटकी फोड़े ग्यो क्या दौड़े गिरधारे गिरधारे मोरले बगाड़े सौने जगाड़े माया लगाड़े मोरारी कहे राधे प्यारी मैं बलिहारी गोकुल आवो गिरदारी रे जिर गोकुल आवो गिरदारी नवरात न मेले बनियल बेले बाव बरेले बप केले हर पत केले कमर कसेले संग सहेले अलबेले बनी चंपक वेले मान भरेले सोण सजेले सण घारे चामुंडा चंडे प्रजा प्रतने असुर विखंडे अवतारे मारे असुर विखंडे अवतारी अंबे मात की
ફિલ્મી સોંગો ઘણા સાંભળવા મળે પણ આવું સંગીત બહુ ઓછું ભણવા મળે અને હવે આપણી કોમ્યુનિટીમાં વન ઓફ ધ બેસ્ટ સિંગર ધેટ આઈ હેવ ઓબ્ઝર્વ એવા દિવ્યેશભાઈ ત્રિપાઠી હાજર છે એમનો પરિચય આપવા માટે હું જગદીશભાઈને વિનંતી કરું એમને પરિચયની જરૂર નથી પણ છતાં
આઈ થિંક દિવ્યેશને બધા ઓળખતા હશે ગુજરાતી સમાજના પ્રોગ્રામ મેનેજર બ્રાહ્મણ સમાજ ઓફ ન્યુયોર્કના ફાઉન્ડર વેસ્ટર્ન ટેમ્પલમાં પણ ઇન્વોલ્વ છે અને કોઈ પણ કોમ્યુનિટી કદાચ કોઈ પણ ઓર્ગેનાઇઝેશન એવી નહીં હોય કે જો આધ્યાત્મિક કેન્દ્રમાં એટલે બધી ઓર્ગેનાઇઝેશન ન્યુયોર્કની ગમે તે હશે તેઓ દિવ્યેશ ત્રિપાઠીનું નામ અચૂક હશે જ અને ઇઝ સો યંગ ગાય્સ એટલે આઈ થિંક આપણા બધા માટે સારું છે કે ઇન્ડો અમેરિકન હમણાં ગયા વીકે જે પાછો મેમ્બર થયો છે અને થોડા ટાઈમ પછી અમારી સેવા કરવા આવશે અમારી એવું લાગે છે. થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ.
સિનિયર થઈ ગયો.
હા હવે તો અમારે જો. અને બીજું એને માઇક આપ્યું પહેલા જણાવું કે જ્યારે મારી ગ્રાન્ડ ડોટર સવારે જે આવીને સ્પીચ આપી હતી એ તો બોક્સ મૂકીને ગઈ છે એટલે કોઈને પણ ઈચ્છા હોય ડોલર બે ડોલર પાંચ ડોલર તો એમને પ્રોત્સાહન કરવા માટે પણ તમે જો કંઈ ડોનેશન કરો તો સારું છે તો ત્યાં બોક્સ મૂકેલું છે તો જતી વખતે એટલું કરતા જજો. થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ દિવ્યાસ.
Thank you so much for introduction. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Boraiah and Vasundhara ji for wonderful information respective your topics. Pleasure to be here. I know time nahi malta all the time program ma, but thank you so much Jagdish bhai for calling me and thank you Pankaj bhai, Mukund uncle, Pakka ji pan ahiya che. Before we start, જેમ પકાજીએ કીધું કે આવતીકાલે પરેડ છે, અમારું પણ ત્યાં સિંગિંગ પરફોર્મન્સ છે પાછું. તો પકાજી તો ગ્રાન્ડ માર્શલ છે, એ બાદે ખાસ જો બધા અનુકૂળ હોય તો જોડાજો. બીજું આપણે જે વાત કરી કે ચંદ્રયાન આપણે 3 સાઉથ પોલ પર પહોંચી ગયું મૂનમાં, ઇઝ પ્રાઉડ મુમેન્ટ ફોર ઓલ ઓફ અસ. ઓફકોર્સ ગ્રેટ ટીમ ઇસરો, કોંગ્રેચ્યુલેશન, એન્ડ અવર ગ્રેટ લીડર રિસ્પેક્ટેડ નરેન્દ્ર મોદીજી. And all of us, is like a, we feel so proud. જે પણ થાય વી ઓલવેઝ પાર્ટ ઓફ ધેટ. અને તમને જેમ પરાગભાઈ કીધું કે યસ, શિવશક્તિ નામ આપ્યું, જ્યાં જે જગ્યાએ ટચ થયું આપણું ચંદ્રયાન 3 એને શિવશક્તિ નામ આપવામાં આવ્યું. અને તમને ખબર છે કે ચંદ્ર પર તો પહોંચી ગયા આપણે સાઉથ પોલ ઉપર, પણ હવે ઓલરેડી એનાઉન્સ પણ કરી દીધું છે આપણા મોદીજીએ કે ભાઈ નાવ નેક્સ્ટ અભિયાન સૂર્ય ઉપર જવાનું છે. If you don't know, no, it's real. It's in the news. Yes. Close to. Means, you know, he tried to be closest to the... Targeting the next to that. And orbit, ma. So, in that song, Dharti jare surya ne male. Tara su anubhav thaye, right? Dharti ma ketlo excitement hove. In that song, ma gavju. બિફોર વી સ્ટાર્ટ, બધાને ખબર જ હશે કે બ્રાહ્મણ સમાજ ઓફ ન્યુયોર્કનો એક સુંદર પ્રોગ્રામ શ્રાવણમાં ચાલી રહ્યો છે. તો શિવ મહાપૂજા અને શિવ કથાનો પ્રોગ્રામ અને પક્કાજીની પ્રેરણાથી આપણે ગુજરાતી સમાજમાં જ આપણે કર્યો છે. અને જે પૂજ્ય ડૉક્ટર લંકેશ બાપુજી જે પધારવાના છે, એ ઇન્ટરનેશનલ શિવ કથાકાર છે. તો આ લાભ ચૂકતા નહીં, હું એમના આશ્રમમાં પણ ત્યાં ગયો હતો અને આઈ વોઝ લિટરલી ઇમ્પ્રેસ. એ ગયા અત્યારે ઓલરાઇટના ઓલરેડી 3 દિવસની એમની કેનેડામાં કથા ચાલી રહી છે. ગયા વીકેન્ડે એ લંડનમાં શિવ કથા એમણે કરી, એટલે આઈ ગ્રેબ ધ ઓપોર્ચ્યુનિટી. મેં કીધું બાપુ તમે જે કેનેડા સુધી આવો છો તો એક દિવસ માટે પ્લીઝ ન્યુયોર્ક પધારો, એટલે એક દિવસ માટે જ ખાલી ન્યુયોર્ક આપણી પૂજા માટે આવવાના છે. તો એનો લાભ લેજો ચોક્કસ.
તારો મેં સજ કે
सूरज से देखो धरती चली मिलने चन की पायल मच गई हलचल अंबर सारा लगा सूरज से देखो धरती चली
mast baharo मस्त बहार का मैं आसिक में जो चाहे यार करूं चाहे ग्लो के साइंस खेलूं चाहे कली से प्यार करूं सारा जहां है मेरे लिए मेरे लिए मस्त बहार का मैं आसिक में जो चाहे यार करूं चाहे ग्लो के साइंस खेलूं चाहे कली से प्यार करूं सारा जहां है मेरे लिए मेरे लिए मैं हूँ वो दीवाना जिसके सब दीवाने हाँ मैं हूँ वो दीवाना जिसके सब दीवाने हाँ किसको है जरूरत तेरी आजमाने हाँ मेरा अपना रास्ता दुनिया से क्या वास्ता मेरे दिल में तमन्नाओं की दुनिया जवां है मेरे लिए मेरे लिए मस्त बहारों का मैं आसिक मैं जो चाहे यार करूं चाहे गुलों के साइंस खेलूं चाहे कली से प्यार करूं सारा जहां है मेरे लिए मेरे लिए मेरी आंखों से जरा आंखें तो मिला दे हाँ मेरी आंखों से जरा आंखें तो मिला दे हाँ मेरी राहें रोक ले नजरे तो बिछा दे हाँ तेरे सर की है कसम मैं जो चला गया सनम तो ये रुत भी चली जाएगी ये तो यहाँ है मेरे लिए मेरे लिए मस्त बहारों का मैं आसिक मैं जो चाहे यार करूं चाहे गुलों के साइंस खेलूं चाहे कली से प्यार करूं सारा जहां है मेरे लिए मेरे लिए सबको ये बता दो कह दो हर नजर से हाँ सबको ये बता दो कह दो हर नजर से हाँ कोई भी मेरे सिवा गुजरे न इधर से हाँ करा दो जहाँ को समझा दो कि जा को आए जाए यहाँ न कोई ये गुलसिता है मेरे मस्त बहारों का मैं आसिक मैं जो चाहे यार करूं चाहे गुलों के साए से खेलूं चाहे कली से प्यार करूं सारा जहां है मेरे लिए 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 मेरे लिए
थैंक यू सो मच वंस अगेन
હલો થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ દિવ્યેશ આજે સમયનો અભાવ છે પણ અમને આશા છે કે ભવિષ્યમાં જરૂરથી તમારો આના કરતાં વધારે લાભ મળશે અને જગદીશભાઈ જેમ મેન્શન કર્યું હવે તો આપણા સભ્ય છે અને એમની જ્યારે વાત કરું ત્યારે હમણાં રિસન્ટલી થયેલા બીજા બે સભ્યોને આપી દઉં તો દશરથભાઈ અને સવિતાબેન પટેલ અને હિરેનભાઈ અને જિગીશાબેન વ્યાસ એ ગઈકાલે જ મેમ્બર થયા તો અમે આ બધા મેમ્બર્સને આપણા ઇન્ડો અમેરિકનના ફેમિલીમાં પરિવારમાં આવકારી દઈએ છીએ નાવ અત્યાર સુધી જે સંગીત સાંભળ્યું બેમાં ઘણો ઘણો ડિફરન્સ હતો એ સિવાયનો પણ વધારે ડિફરન્સ પડી શકે એવા એક સિંગર જેને છુપા રુસ્તમ કહું હું કારણ કે હું એમને ઓળખતો હતો ઘણા વખતથી પણ એમની આ ટેલેન્ટ વિશે હમણાં બસ ટ્રીપમાં ગયા ત્યારે જ ખબર પડી એવા ડૉક્ટર મધુકરભાઈ શાહ ડૉક્ટર મધુકરભાઈ શાહ 1940 થી 1960ના જે ગીતો છે એના સારા સિંગર છે પંકજ મલિક સાયગલ જગમોહન એવા બધા લોકોને ખૂબ સારો ન્યાય આપી શકે એવા સિંગર છે તો વ્યવસાય ડૉક્ટર છે અને એ તો એ ખબર પડી ગઈ હશે જ્યારે એમને સવાલો પૂછ્યા ત્યારે કે એ ડૉક્ટર છે તો એમને રિક્વેસ્ટ કરું કે એમના એકદમ સુધ વેરી સુધિંગ એવા મ્યુઝિકનો આપણને લાભ આવે
થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ થેન્ક યુ પીપલ અપ ઓર ગીવ યુ ધ સ્લીપિંગ પિલ ઓર વેક અપ પિલ એક ગાયન જૂનું
દિલ કો હૈ તુમસે દિલ કો હૈ તુમસે પ્યાર ક્યું યે ના બતા સકુંગા મૈં ये न बता सकूंगा मैं दिल को है तुमसे प्यार क्यों दिल को है तुमसे प्यार क्यों तुमको नजर में रख लिया दिल में जिगर में रख लिया તુમકો નજર મે રખ લિયા દિલ મે જિગર મે રખ લિયા ફિર મેં હુઆ શિકાર ક્યું યે ન બતા સકુંગા મેં ફિર મેં હુઆ શિકાર ક્યું યે ન બતા સકુંગા મેં रूप की कुछ कमी नहीं दुनिया में एक तुम ही नहीं रूप की कुछ कमी नहीं दुनिया में एक तुम ही
सकूंगा मैं ये न बता सकूंगा मैं दिल को है तुमसे प्यार क्यों तेरे मंदिर का हूँ दीपक जल रहा तेरे मंदिर का हूँ दीपक जल रहा आग जीवन में मैं भर कर चल रहा तेरे मंदिर का हूँ दीपक जल रहा क्या तू मेरे दर्द से अनजान है क्या तेरी मेरी नई पहचान है क्यों बिना पानी पता सा जल रहा आग जीवन में मैं भर कर चल तेरे मंदिर का हूँ दीपक जल रहा एक झलक मुझको दिखा दे सांवरे मुझको ले चल तू गगन की छाँव में और चलिया क्यों मुझे तू चल रहा आग जीवन में मैं भर कर चल रहा तेरे मंदिर का हूँ दीपक चल रहा
Thank you very much. Just 1 minute. Yes, Dr. K.
Sorry, one more thing I forgot to mention. I think I mentioned before that we got a grant from from the Senate U.S. Congress member here, Tom Swazi. He gave $500,000 to India Home to educate our community about the colon cancer importance of colon cancer screening. So that we are going to actually in collaboration with Gujarati Samaj, we are having a health fair together on September 24th. So that time we will get our GI specialist doctors and then educate the community. And before that, of course, we would do some survey about the what is the knowledge about this in the community, how important it is, whether the doctors are telling them that it is important and things like that. So you would receive this information also. And one more thing also, I think Aarti Foundation is having some musical program on October 7th. What we do, India Home, is always we want to subsidize the tickets. It's $15, India Home will subsidize $5. So you pay only $10. So that way, you know, because we wanted our seniors to go and enjoy everything what is available. If we can reduce, even if it is $5 or whatever it is, you know, some people will say, okay, let me go. What's the big deal about it, right? So that was, and at the same time, our fundraising tickets also, Indo-American Senior Citizen Group is a not-for-profit group. Not-for-profit group rates are different. Normally we charge 200, but it's 150 for not-for-profit group members, whether it is Gujarati Samaj members or Indo-American senior citizen group members. So that way, you know, it is on October 22nd, which is on Terrace on the Park. It is going to be in the daytime again, because we wanted to make every program around lunchtime, so that, you know, people should not feel like it is in the nighttime, I can't go home. And there is a little confusion about the Broadway show, because a couple of people asked, I want to clarify. There are two Broadway shows. One is Lion King, one is Aladdin, right? There are two dates, Saturday dates, which is 9th of September, 16th of September at 2 o'clock. Imagine you want to see Aladdin first, go for Aladdin on 9th. And 16th, you can go for the other show, Lion King, right? And if your family members, you know, for whatever reason it is, they say, okay, we all wanted to go together, like your children and grandchildren. But we are not free on Saturday because we have practice or whatever it is. Then you request Geeta, you call her and tell her, our kids wanted to go on Friday evening or when, you know, some evening at 7 o'clock show. We will make an exception for that family to reserve, because your children should realize having a senior at home is very useful for them, right? That's why we will make exception for those families who wanted to come with their children and grandchildren on weekdays whenever it is convenient, so that the children will drive you to city and bring you back. So that's important, but otherwise these 2 days. Sorry, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. So Arati ticket, we have around 65 tickets and mostly it will be taken by our members. So Ramesh bhai, you can start selling the tickets to our member Arati tickets for $10 instead of 50. And whoever has already paid, you can refund them. People who have already paid $15, they can get a refund. And the difference for paying to Arati, we will get it from India Home. Okay. Now, we are very near to the end of the program. Laughter is very important. Actually, we wanted to show some video clips today, but we have come up to the end with music and all that. So we have one short clip about somebody pulling leg on phone, and it is so much full of laughter. Listen it carefully. Not only listen, whenever you feel like laughing, burst into laughter, do that. So it is around, I think, less than 5 minutes of clip, and you can start.
What's the title?
Just start, I'll tell you if it is wrong. I'm not, Nakenikal Rao, barabar. Okay. Barabar, Nakenikal Rao.
जल्दी शुरू करो अने जरा लाउड
थोड़ी शांति राखो तो संभळवानी मजा आवशे
Thank you.
હેલો આઈ એમ સોરી આ એક ક્લિપ ખરેખર સુવા જેવી અને સરસ હતી પાછળના ડિસ્ટર્બન્સને કારણે જે વિક્ષેપ પડ્યો માટે સોરી હું નિરંજનભાઈને ઇન્વાઇટ કરું છું આપણો છેલ્લો પ્રોગ્રામ છે છેલ્લો કાર્યક્રમ ઓગસ્ટ માસની અંદર જેમની પણ બર્થડે અને મેરેજ એનિવર્સરી આવે એ આપણે સેલિબ્રેટ કરીશું અને એના માટે નિરંજન
ઓલરાઈટ આપણા મેમ્બરમાંથી અત્યારે જે હાજર છે એમાંથી જેની ઓગસ્ટ મહિનામાં બર્થડે હોય એ પહેલા અહીંયા આવી જાય ઓગસ્ટમાં બર્થડે ઓનલી સોલો હા હા અમે ઉંમર નથી પૂછતા એટલે એમને એમ જ આવી જાઓ જેને બર્થડે સોંગ કોઈ સરસ ગઈ શકે એવું છે ફર્સ્ટ નું ગાયન તમને જે તમને જે ગમે બર્થડે નું કોઈ બી
તમે ગામી
ને બાર મહિના હોય છે
બાર બાર દિન આય બાર બાર દિન
Happy birthday to
birthday.
હવે ઓગસ્ટ મહિનામાં જેની મેરેજ એનિવર્સરી આવતી હોય એ લોકો અહીં આવી જાય. ચાલો યાર, હેપી બર્થડે. એનિવર્સરી વાળા આવી જાઓ અહીંયા ઓગસ્ટ મહિનામાં, જેની બી એનિવર્સરી આવતી હોય તે.
મને
આપું નથી આવતું.
જબ કોઈ બાપ બિગડ જાય, જબ કોઈ મુશ્કિલ અડ જાય, તું દેના સાથ મેરા સફર. જબ કોઈ બાત બિગડ જાય, જબ કોઈ મુશ્કિલ પડ જાય, તું દેના સાથ મેરા હમ સફા. થેન્ક યુ.
આપણો પ્રોગ્રામ હજી પૂરો થયો નથી એટલે જે લોકો પાછળ ટેબલ પાસે ઉભા છે એમને રિક્વેસ્ટ કે તમારી જગ્યા લઈ લો. આપણી છેલ્લી આઈટમ proposing the vote of thanks એ હજી બાકી છે અને we will observe the discipline. એમને બધાને કહો રમેશભાઈ કે એ લોકો બધા બધાની જગ્યા લઈ લે અને વોટ ઓફ થેન્ક પ્રપોઝ કરવા માટે. હા ઓકે, આપણે પ્રપોઝ વોટ ઓફ થેન્ક્સ કરીએ પહેલાં આપણો નેક્સ્ટ પ્રોગ્રામ કયો છે એની માહિતી નરેન્દ્રભાઈ આપે.
તમે જાણો છો એ પ્રમાણે આપણે હંમેશા એક વેલ્યુ બેઝ પ્રોગ્રામ કરીએ છીએ. તો હવે પછીનો આપણો પ્રોગ્રામ 10th સપ્ટેમ્બર સન્ડેના દિવસે આ જ જગ્યાએ, અને એમાં આપણે બોલાવ્યા છે વેલ નોન નેફ્રોલોજિસ્ટ ડૉક્ટર કેનાર ઝવેરી. તો એ આપણને કિડની વિશે, નેફ્રોલોજિસ્ટ વિશે વધારે જ્ઞાન આપશે. અને ત્યારબાદ આપણે દર વર્ષે આધ્યાત્મિક વિકાસ કેન્દ્રનો ભજનનો પ્રોગ્રામ રાખીએ છીએ, એ પ્રમાણે સેકન્ડ હાફમાં આધ્યાત્મિક વિકાસ કેન્દ્રના સભ્યો દ્વારા ભજનનો પ્રોગ્રામ છે. તો જરૂર પધારશો 10th સપ્ટેમ્બર સન્ડે આ જ જગ્યાએ.
અને હવે રિક્વેસ્ટ કરું વિનીતાબેનને, ડૉક્ટર વિનીતાબેન શાહ, ટુ પ્રપોઝ વોટ ઓફ થેન્ક્સ. વિનીતાબેન
ગુડ આફ્ટરનૂન એવરીવન. એક બહુ જ જાણીતું લોકગીતથી યાદ કરીને શરૂઆત કરું છું, કદાચ મોટાભાગના લોકોએ સાંભળ્યું જ હશે. એની બે પંક્તિઓ મને યાદ આવે છે. મારી સાસુએ એમ કહ્યું કે ગોખમાં દીવો મેલ, મેં ભોળીએ એમ માન્યું કે સાસુની સોડમાં દીવો મેલ. મહેંદી લેશું મહેંદી મોટા ઝાડ. પંકજભાઈનો મારા પર ફોન આવ્યો કે આરપીને ઇન્ટ્રોડક્શન આપવાની છે ડૉક્ટર બોરૈયાની, અને તમે આભાર વિધિ કરજો. એટલે મેં ભોળીએ એમ માની લીધું કે મારે ડૉક્ટર બોરૈયાની જ આભાર વિધિ કરવાની હોય ને, એટલે મેં બહુ જ નાની પેપરમાં ઇંગ્લિશમાં 4-5 લાઈનો લખી. અહીંયા આવીને મને ખબર પડી કે અરે મારે તો આખા પ્રોગ્રામ પછી આભાર વિધિ કરવાની છે. એટલે ધડાધડ મેં ગુજરાતીમાં આ બે કાગળો લખ્યા અહીંયા બેસીને. એટલે એટલી ભોળી હું છું. ઓફકોર્સ ઇન્ડો અમેરિકન સિનિયર સેન્ટર ઓફ ન્યુયોર્ક અંડર ધ લીડરશીપ ઓફ જગદીશભાઈ એઝ એ પ્રેસિડન્ટ અને પંકજભાઈ એઝ એ વાઇસ પ્રેસિડન્ટ, આટલો સુંદર પ્રોગ્રામ આજે આયોજન થયું એના માટે ખૂબ ખૂબ આભાર, અને એન્ટાયર એક્ઝિક્યુટિવ કમિટીનો, કારણ કે એ બધા જ એમના બેકબોન તરીકે સર્વ કરે છે, એટલે એ બધાનો ખૂબ ખૂબ આભાર. એની સાથે મારો મિત્ર શ્યામ, મારો મેડિકલ સ્કૂલનો ક્લાસમેટ શ્યામ, એને પણ આ ડૉક્ટર બોરૈયાને અહીંયા લાવવામાં જે મદદ કરી નોર્થવેલના એના એસોસિએશન સાથે, એના માટે પણ શ્યામ ખૂબ ખૂબ આભાર. આપણા રિસ્પેક્ટેડ મુકુંદભાઈ પરામર્શક એમણે અહીંયા બહુ જ ગ્રેસિયસલી આ ઓકેઝનમાં એટેન્ડન્સ આપી અને અમને બ્લેસિંગ્સ આપ્યા, એના માટે પણ ખૂબ ખૂબ આભાર. આશાબેન ધારાવતે શરૂઆત કરી સુંદર પ્રાર્થના ગીતથી, એના માટે ખૂબ આભાર. ઓફકોર્સ બિફોર આઈ ફરગેટ, બધા ઓડિયન્સ, તમે બધા જ મિત્રો અને સિનિયર મેમ્બર્સ આટલા બધા કલાક અહીંયા શાંતિથી બેઠા અને આ પ્રોગ્રામ એન્જોય કર્યો. તમે ના હો તો બધા સ્પીકર્સ કે આ ગાયન ગાનારાનો કોઈ મિનિંગ નથી, એટલે તમારો ખૂબ 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 પહેલા જ આભાર માની લો. બિગ એપ્લોઝ ટુ એવરી વન. આપણને એન્ટરટેઇન કરનારા પરાગભાઈ પટેલ, આધ્યાત્મિક વિકાસ કેન્દ્રના દિવ્યેશ ત્રિપાઠી, ઓફકોર્સ દિવ્યેશ મને તો ખૂબ યાદ છે, આરપીના ડ્રામાનો, અમારા આરપીના ડ્રામાનો હીરો. એના પછી એનું જે આ મેટામોર્ફોસિસ થયું છે, પ્રોગ્રામ મેનેજર ગુજરાતી સમાજનો, બ્રાહ્મણ સમાજનો, એ દિવ્યેશનો પણ આજે એક નવી મલ્ટી ટેલેન્ટ ઓળખાઈ ગાનાર પણ છે, એનો પણ ખૂબ આભાર. અને ડૉક્ટર મધુકર શાહ, ખૂબ સુંદર જૂના ગીતો સંભળાવ્યા, ખૂબ ખૂબ આભાર. જતીનભાઈ એ તો આપણી સાથે ક્રુઝમાં હોય કે ગમે તે પ્રોગ્રામમાં હોય, એમના ટેકનિકલ આસ્પેક્ટ વગર, આ વિડીયોગ્રાફી અને સાઉન્ડ સિસ્ટમ વગર કશું જ પોસિબલ નથી, એટલે જતીન ખૂબ ખૂબ આભાર. મારી છેલ્લા લાસ્ટ બટ નોટ ધ લિસ્ટ, મારા બેટર હાફ, મારે બધાની હાજરીમાં તેવું જ કહેવું પડે કે મારા બેટર હાફ છે, ડૉક્ટર આરપી શાહ, ઇન્ટ્રોડ્યુસ કરવા માટે ડૉક્ટર બોરૈયાનો. મારા ઘરે તો પંકજભાઈ આજે 52 વર્ષના લગ્ન જીવનમાં આજે હોળી થઈ હતી, કારણ કે આરપી ઇઝ એ પ્રોકાસ્ટિનેટર, એટલે છેલ્લી મિનિટે 10:30 વાગે એમણે સ્પીચ લખવાની શરૂ કરી, અને મને એને લીધે બહુ જ ગભરામણ થાય કે નહીં, આવું આટલું બધું છેલ્લી મિનિટે નહીં કરવાનું, બધું પ્રોપરલી પ્લાન કરો, પછી કમ્પ્યુટર પર સ્પીચ લખે, પછી પાછું એને પ્રિન્ટ આઉટ કરે, આ બધી ધમાલ 10:30 વાગે શરૂ થાય. એટલે આજે ખરેખર અમારા 52 વર્ષના લગ્નની આજે એક કસોટી હતી, આઈ થિંક એમાંથી અમે પાર પડ્યા એવું લાગે છે. જો આ બધામાં હું કોઈનો આભાર માનવાનું ભૂલી ગઈ હોઉં તો મને જરૂરથી માફ કરશો. ડૉક્ટર બોરૈયાએ તો ઘણા બધા સિનિયર મિત્રોની સર્જરી કરી છે, અને તમને બધાને આટલા કોન્ફિડન્સથી, યુ આર વોકિંગ સ્ટેન્ડિંગ ટોલ વિથ એ કોન્ફિડન્સ અને વોકિંગ વિથ એ કોન્ફિડન્સ, પ્લીઝ કન્ટિન્યુ દેટ, બીકોઝ ધીઝ આર ધ મોસ્ટ સિનિયર યર્સ યુ આર એન્જોઈંગ વિથ એ ગુડ હેલ્થ. સો ઓલ ધ મિત્રો જે લોકોની આજે વર્ષગાંઠ ઉજવાઈ અને જે લોકોની મેરેજ એનિવર્સરી ઉજવાઈ, એ બધાને પણ ખૂબ ખૂબ અભિનંદન, અને એન્જોય યોર લાઈફ ટુ ધ ફૂલેસ્ટ. અને છેલ્લે I cannot forget being a pediatrician, Jagdish Boraiah's granddaughter, and any banne mitroe, je atlu saras kaam kari raha chhe, and fundraising for the Children's Cancer Society. So please, please, ek mari personal plea chhe ke jata, jarur thi pehla box ma donation mukine jajo. And I think ek bahu agatyani varvidhi bhuli gai. India Home. Oh, how can I forget? President Vasundhara Ben. Oh, Deputy Director. Oh, Executive Director. And President Mukund Bhai. Amazing kaam karo cho. Amazing, amazing. Really, hats off to entire team of India Home. And khare kar. And plus, aajno program pan tamme sponsor karyo. Itle ene maate pan khub 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 aabhar. And plus, બે બહુ સરસ બ્રોડવે શોઝ બિંગ એ ન્યુયોર્કર અલ્લાદીન અને લાયન કિંગ વાવ હાઉ કેન યુ ગો રોંગ ટેક યોર ગ્રાન્ડ કિડ્સ મેં તો મારી ઓલરેડી અનફોર્ચ્યુનેટલી ટિકિટ બાય કરી દીધી છે મારી ગ્રાન્ડ ડોટરને હું સપ્ટેમ્બરની 8મી તારીખે લઈ જવાની છું અલ્લાદીનમાં પણ આઈ એમ ગોઈંગ ટુ બાય લાયન કિંગ નાવ ઓલ્સો સો થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ અને તમે આજે બીજું બધું બી સબસિડાઇઝ કરો છો આરટી ફાઉન્ડેશનની ટિકિટ્સ ને બધું Amazing work, amazing, and thank you very much, and khub khub abhar. Thank you all for your attention and listening to me. Thank you.
Je thank you kevanu baki rahi gayu, e Binita ben. Atla entertaining way ma, atli badhi clarity and atla badha humorous way ma, મેં કોઈ વોટ ઓફ થેન્ક્સ ખાયેલા સાંભળ્યા નથી વોટ ઓફ થેન્ક્સમાં સામાન્ય રીતે બધા લોકો ઊભા થઈને ચાલતા થઈ જાય આ તો હજી સાંભળવાનું મન થાય એવી થેન્ક્સ ગિવિંગ થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ તો હા આરપી બચાવો આરપી આરપી હોળી કરી હોળી થઈ હતી એના વિશે કંઈક કહે
સર્જરીની વાત કરીને એ બહુ ધ્યાનથી લેજો એ ટેકનિક પ્રિસાઇઝ છે એમને બી શબ્દ આપ્યો પ્રિસિઝન તમને એટલા માટે કહું છું કે ખાલી યુટ્યુબની અંદર આ તો તમે જોજો જ જોજો જે જેને સર્જરી કરવાની છે કે કરેલી હોય તો પણ સર્જરી યુટ્યુબની અંદર એટલા સરસ વિડીયો છે કમ્પ્યુટર એસિસ્ટેડ એટલે કમ્પ્યુટર કરતું નથી પણ પેલા ડોક્ટરનો હાથ પકડે છે અને કમ્પ્યુટર એ ડોક્ટર જ પોતે હાથ મૂકી દે એટલે ક્યાં અગાડી એ ખીલો ઠોકવાનો છે ચૂક મૂકવાની છે એ બરાબર પ્રિસાઇઝ કરીને આપે છે કારણ કે મોનિટર પર કમ્પ્યુટરે બધું નક્કી કર્યું છે કે અહીં અગાડી 1.25 ઇંચ ઉપર પેલો નેલ મારવાનો છે એટલે આ ખાસ જોજો બોરૈયાની હાજરીમાં મારે એ કહેવું નહોતું નહીં તો એને એવું લાગે કે અમે કંઈક કિંમત કરતા નથી તમે પણ એટલે તમે કમ્પ્યુટર એસિસ્ટેડ વિડીયો જોજો જ જોજો એ પહેલું અને એક બેને એવું કહેલું હતું અને એમને પણ એવું કહ્યું કે ડાક્ટર બહુ સરસ હોય તો બધું ખરાબ હશે પણ એને બહુ સરસ જોક માર્યો કે બંડલ ડાક્ટર હોય તો કમ્પ્યુટર પાસે કરાવડાવજો છે કેમ કે પહેલાંની કાનપટ્ટી પકડે એટલા માટે એટલે એ ખાસ એક યાદ રાખજો બીજું કે વસુંધરા શી ટોક્સ સો ગુડ તો સુધા મૂર્તિને પણ સાંભળજો તમે There is so much similarity. જે મહાન વ્યક્તિઓ હોય છે એ પણ ઘણી વાર બધું સામ્ય હોય છે તો સુધામૂર્તિને સાંભળજો વસુંધરાને સાંભળજો થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ
થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ આરપી આ બધા આ બધું જે થઈ રહ્યું છે વેલ્યુ એડિશન થઈ રહ્યું છે આપણે તો વેલ્યુ બેઝ પ્રોગ્રામ કરીએ છીએ પણ આવા શ્રોતાઓ અને આવા પાર્ટિસિપન્ટ મળે તો એમાં જે વેલ્યુ એડિશન થાય એનો આપણને લાભ મળે થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ હજી કઈ વેલ્યુ એડિશન તો આજનો પ્રોગ્રામ આપણે પૂરો જાહેર કરીએ છીએ અને જતી વખતે ઇન્ડિયા હોમની $8 કુપન લેતા જજો અગેન કહું તો ઉષા ફૂડની
ઉષા ફૂડની એક કુપનમાં પણ ઇન્ડિયા હોમનું નામ લખેલું છે. ઓકે, હવે એક કુપનમાં ફરીથી કહી દઉં, આજે જ એનો ઉપયોગ કરવો જરૂરી નથી, આખા અઠવાડિયા સુધી કરી શકશો. અને ત્યાં બેસીને જમવું પણ જરૂરી નથી, ત્યાંથી તમે કંઈ પણ પરચેસ કરી શકો. એક બીજી માહિતી આપી દઉં કે ત્યાં બેસીને જો જમો તો $8 વસ્તુ મળે, ઉપરાંત ચાનો કપ ફ્રી મળશે એવી આપણી વ્યવસ્થા કરેલી છે. યુ કેન આસ્ક ફોર એ ફ્રી કપ ઓફ ટી, સો દેટ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો એ પાર્ટ ઓફ ઇટ. સો ઓલ ધ બેસ્ટ, થેન્ક યુ.